It's time, guys, for picks and bans for game number one between Jin Air Green Wings and the KU Tigers. And I wonder if that Elise is getting through. There's a Kennen ban against KU. Interesting.
Well, remember that we have seen KU play Kennen. Particularly, Smeb actually had a very good Kennen game at one point. But that's a bit curious. That's the first Kennen ban that we've seen quite some time. Maokai.
A lot of engage being taken away by Jin Air. I think they know exactly what they need to be worried about against KU here.
Well, they just don't want Gorilla to wander around getting kills in the laning phase, which he's very good at with the Annie pick.
Yep.
And they're trying to ban out Trace here. I would imagine that KU is gunning for a first round red side rumble so that they can force Trace onto something that it requires more farm, which has not been Jin Air's strength. When he gets things like Ryze or Hecarim, it doesn't do too well because he just doesn't get the resources, and he's not the kind of player who can really thrive on those champions. So Braum will be the last ban. Of course, Braum and Annie were all five of Gorilla's last five games.
Gorilla certainly has a deeper champion pool than that, though, so not a lot to worry for KU. Initially, they banned the Elise rather than the Ryze, and Tracers is going to grab that right away, but that may play right into KU's hands.
Just the last two times Jin Air has had Ryze, they've lost. GBM played it, Trace played it. Trace fell very far behind on the Ryze, and Jin Air made some really questionable team fight calls versus Anarchy before the Ryze had time to scale. They tried to fight on a Rod of Ages and it had barely any stacks and a tier. You can't fight like that with Ryze like that right now.
That GBM game with Ryze was so bizarre because you look at GBM and for a guy that on Xerath like never misses a skill shot ever, for him to miss nearly every Q in that game, it was very bizarre to see. So now are the first champion picked up by the KU Tigers, and then they're going to lock in the Rek'Sai as well.
Yep, so the Gnar a bit of a surprise, but maybe they're anticipating the Rumble, and they want the Gnar into Rumble matchup for Smeb to have an upper hand when it comes to harassment. Kuzan was a good LeBlanc player, but Azir much more likely here, unless they want to go for the Victor. Now, Kuro no longer professionally undefeated on Victor, sadly, but still his best champion, and up and ready for use.
Well, Azir is the only champion that Kuzan has played more than once. He's got three games on it this season, and a lot of his other picks, LeBlanc, Lissandra, not really something we're going to see in the meta right now, so not surprising at all that we see him locking that Azir. And it will be the Lee Sin for Winged as well.
Yeah, we're seeing more and more Lee Sin these days.
Yeah.
People prioritizing some of these early game junglers, and I think that's a great pickup. If he's not going to take Nidalee, which he could, has a lot of synergy with Ryze for ganking in the top side. But this is another good champion to try and get kills onto this Ryze in the early game. So Jin Air switching it up a little bit. And here we go. Will it be the Janna and the Kog'Maw?
Looks like it will. The Janna's been locked in. Still thinking about the Kog'Maw, but if they pick a Lulu up along with this, how do you think Lulu does in lane versus the Azir? Poke is there.
Yeah,
it's not bad.
This is going to be a farm lane, and I assume we're going to see Juggernaut from the KU Tigers. Of course, the team that invented that strategy and then brought it to a large amount of popularity, not only in Korea, but all around the globe.
Yep. And then agonizingly losing to the Kog'Maw in that
the Juggernaut
game two against KD. It hurts bad.
Hoisted by their own petard.
That's right. Never forget.
All right, petard. So Sivir may be the pick here just so they can get Ryze easily into combat. Top Ryze not able to run the Ghost. And they need some way to threaten the back line because they don't have a lot of engage besides the... I would take Alistar here instead of the Thresh, just so you have a reliable form of primary engage. I'd be very worried about KU kiting in this particular matchup, and they could go for Victor too, provide another damage threat. That's what they're going to do.
That.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, so Victor locked in for Kuro, and again, he only has one loss on that champion ever.
Well, it's his best champion, no doubt.
Yeah.
But,
well,
he's
like a Victor hipster, man.
It's true.
He's playing
a Vixter.
Yep, Vixter.
Well,
a Hipster.
In this particular matchup, obviously, you don't have the shield to block the Sand Soldier damage, so Victor can be traded out early. Azir does tend to have a bit of an edge.
True, and you have to wonder if they let Kuro push up in lane a little bit, how unsafe he would be against Wing's Lee Sin. Might be a little bit dangerous as well.
Yeah, and looks like Kuzan will be taking the heal in this one. Victor with the barrier, actually. Okay. So very safe Victor play in this particular game. Maybe he just wants to be able to survive some of the Rise Burst, but...
Sounds like Kuro.
Neither team has reliable engage. Neither one. Smet will have to flash Gnar or a flash knockup from Wisdom. That's about all they've got. Meanwhile, on Jhinnir's side, they have Sivir. They're really reliant on a Thresh Hook or a Lee Sin kick to actually engage a fight. Remember, the Azir initiation with the ultimate is no longer as reliable now that you don't get the knockup on the E. So it's changed quite a bit in terms of how you can use him in a team composition.
That's right. It is time, guys. Let's get in the game. Jhinnir versus Ku Tigers. Let's see who takes it. You know, another thing to consider here as we move on to Summoner's Rift for game number one between Jhinnir Greenwings and the Ku Tigers is that they got absolutely raffle stomped by Gnar in their last time out too.
Yeah.
They just decided they wanted to get ulted against walls. At least three of them.
Yes.
It was different players, but still, they really did seem to think that the Gnar ult range was just like the go-to place to party in that game.
Yeah, Ixu did a great job.
Yeah.
And the main issue with that, Doa, is Smeb is a much better Gnar player.
That's true. I mean, Ixu hasn't been bad here and there as far as a top laner goes as well, if you compare him to players like Soul, I suppose. But Smeb is a whole different level, man. I mean, yeah.
Of course, always in the conversation when we talk about the best top laners in this league.
Which is so bizarre after last year that Smeb have had. But 2015 has been really good for the Gnar, and he will gentleman his way down the river back into his own side of the map.
Why does a gentleman have a boomerang? Is that something that gentlemen have now?
It's not as clumsy or random as a blaster, that's why. It's a more civilized weapon for a more elegant weapon civilized age.
I think he throws a cane or a walking stick, actually.
Oh, all right.
Coming to look at it right now.
That's not as civilized. Welcome to the studio!
So, we'll see how this goes with Frey and Smeb and Wisdom starting down on the bottom side. They will get the Kog'Maw into Sivir matchup, able just to poke out with that one. So that's Janna. Janna Kog'Maw always very annoying because of how much power that poke has with the Janna shield, the extra AD onto the Kog'Maw.
We'll see how that lane ends up going. This lane is going about as expected. Kuzan should be able to push Kuro up pretty aggressively. You know, if I was Kog'Maw with that skin, I'd be really worried about like hitting my own little hanging like lure thing with my spittle.
Your bioluminescent lure.
It's like, oh, I spit on my own lure again. I wish it wasn't hanging in front of my mouth.
You know, it only works in the dark, too. I wonder why Kog'Maw has that here.
And as an ADC, you don't really want to do things that let people know where you are better.
Well, see, that's the perfect skin for the Juggernaut, though, Doa.
That's true. That is true. He's just leading the way, man. He's like the Rudolph of this this group.
He could be using the Rudolph skin, in fact, if he wanted to.
He could. Why isn't he? He would lead their slaying tonight. Another play from Che causes some dismay for Prey.
It does. And just walking up that close in this particular situation gets a lot of damage down, and Sivir using those early levels to make some plays right here. Trace was given the blue buff, as we can see, but guess who wants it? It's Wisdom.
It's like I'm a jungler.
330 gank, here we go.
Yeah, but where's the top lane? There we go, Smeb hopping in. They force a flash out of Trace right away, and so that is basically just an open ticket for Wisdom to come back later and kill him.
Trace is one of the most difficult top laners to gank because he will sacrifice farm just to stay safe. Really quite challenging to kill him in the laning phase.
And with a champion like Ryze, too, it's not the end of the world if you die once or twice in lane early on, as long as you can keep up and farm.
That said, he doesn't have TP anymore. It's going to be a while, I think, before he can go back and actually get his tiers. So that stacking is going to be delayed in this particular game.
At least he's got a ward, and that's letting him push up very aggressively. He's also got Wink coming into the top lane as well, too, just in case.
So this missing CS that he should hit right there, but that's okay. That is smart. It's how you play with the Rumble on your team, too. If the Ryze needs to go back, then you want to push up that wave. But Trey's actually making no moves. No sign of going back yet. We normally see somebody going for a tier about this time. Looks like he doesn't have enough money.
He's got the wards right now to be perfectly safe. Being aggressive in lane. Nope, not anymore. The River Ward just went away. So you may need Wing to drop by and use his Trinket.
Well, in the meantime, he is going to be zoned off that wave because he is very...
Can't push up now.
Very nervous about what could be going on right here. Smab level 5, one level up to Trace, and not going to be
so
able
worried.
To get the cannon. He should be worried.
Yeah.
He should be very worried without that flash, but this is just Trace. It's how he plays the game.
Yep.
But it does cause some CS problems, and when we're talking about... If you don't need items, if you're playing Rumble or you're playing Maokai and the item's not so important to your skirmishing, but if you're playing a ramping top laner that needs to carry with damage and with items like Ryze does, it delays you so much, makes that power spike way later.
You know, if we look down the bottom lane, interestingly enough, Captain Jack has been able to get a nice little CS lead over Prey. It's not too uneven yet. But they are really pushing that lane.
Yep, they're doing a good job just denying it into the turret. They know that Bray doesn't have the wave clear yet until he gets his ultimate. And they are making good use of their superior duo lane for the wave clear pre-6. Nicely done by Jhenair. I like how aggressively Che is playing onto Kog'Maw too, also causing him to miss some farm.
Well, it seems like they're really making the assumption as well that Ku Tigers are going to focus on this top lane as far as where to send the jungler, and so they can be aggressive in the 2v2.
And they'd be right. And now they know Wisdom is in the top side. They saw him with a ward, and in a way, this is also to try and get Wisdom to come down there so they can get the farm necessary for Trace to scale. Doubles down on the wards for just a moment while the other one expires. Nice overlapping wards. We do see Winged here thinking about heading into the lane. He doesn't want to go into the jungle right now. They have not seen Wisdom since he entered on that ramp.
Yeah, and he could have just left through the bottom area too. I don't know if that ward quite covers it enough, so being cautious for sure.
No, especially with the brush there.
Yeah. So he might not be in there. Yep, Wing coming in now.
Uh-oh.
Looking around, Wisdom is going to find it. Wisdom doesn't hit the Prey Seeker, doesn't hit the knockup either. And now Winged actually able to get some decent damage in on the Rek'Sai, but there's a chilling smite.
Yeah, they have to be careful. Smet was coming down. Also, Wisdom is up a Ruby Crystal.
Yeah. Oh, action down the bot lane. Che taking a lot of damage. Gets himself a shield from the Lantern.
No mana from Prey really to follow up
on
that to get any kind of kill, but still... Preferable trade there for Jhenair, although Che still has biscuits. Meanwhile, Gorilla is fresh out.
Out of biscuits. Prey's been able to catch up a little bit in CS as well, too, so they're starting to swing this lane back into their favor. And as Prey hits 6, that'll probably be even more so.
Oh no,
not the cannon minion.
Close, but Prey right behind there. So. Tier now for Trace. That is a really late one that he is going to grab. Also, just with a Sapphire Crystal right now for some extra damage. Smab going to take this time to recall. He is already 30 CS in the lead at 8.5 minutes. This is a very, very bad sign for Jhenair.
Yeah, I mean, this is really kind of the typical early game we've expected from these guys, though they do oftentimes fall behind. And I don't know. The thing is the longer that Ryze takes the ramp, the more vulnerable they're going to be to losing those mid-late game team fights.
Yep, and Ryze right now going to have problems finishing up his Hex Drinker. He has stats to be a bully in that laning phase, and Trace is just simply working on the tier stacks and then the Rod of Ages.
You can tell they were really ready for that Ryze pick from Jhin Air.
Well, they have been prioritizing it.
Yeah, a little bit.
Even on this patch this week, we saw them first pick it. So,
yeah.
In spite of the nerfs, Jhin Air likes taking that, and they've been putting it onto Trace. So, clearly, Smeb was confident in that matchup. Of course, it could have gone mid. And I don't know what Kuro would have done in that particular instance, but saved it the mid lane pick until last, so he knew exactly what he was getting into. Azir also picked up pretty early by the Jhin Air Green Wings.
Nice wards by Ku Tigers in the bottom jungle of Jhin Air as well, too. They really have a good read on where Winged is right now.
Yes, they do. Not too much danger. Not the enemy jungler. Meanwhile, Wisdom shrouded in darkness. No wards in his jungle whatsoever. And that's going to cause Trace to continue to be nervous about engaging this Gnar.
It's interesting to see, really, just how Vision is impacting the CS in top lane so much.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it's just how it is. If you can't feel safe, you can't farm, and it's not even about the 1v1. It's just about what Trace feels safe doing.
Right, and maybe Trace should be playing this more forward. He can get the wards down with the help of Winged, but you have a certain point you have to make a trade-off, and you have to ask, if I could be even in CS right now, is it worth having a death? Is it worth giving up that first blood? And I think maybe the answer is yes, honestly, because you have to ramp in this game. It is your job to do that.
Yeah. Yeah, one early death, you know, giving a little bit of gold to the enemy jungler, the enemy top laner, is not worth giving up the, you know, the late game that your team needs to win.
It is a bit of a question, because if Smeb gets ahead, of course, he can be very tanky, too.
Whoa,
tanky for you to
divide,
kill.
Used on to Kuro. Kuro drops that Chaos Storm. Kuzan just sitting in there because of the gravity field, not taking a ton of damage, though. Here comes Wisdom. Now, Wisdom had put down a tunnel in the bot lane, so I was wondering if he was thinking of trying for some sort of gank there, but with the action mid, he had to use it to come and make sure Kuro was okay.
Yeah, just simply going there in case Lee Sin were to show up or anything like that. Yep. He had to get back on the map anyway, and now he's going to be able to do a little bit of counter-jungling and get some more deep wards in. The freedom that Wisdom and Gorilla have had this game to get deep wards in is something that is quite disturbing. Jhin Air needs to protect that. They shouldn't be able to get deep wards on two sides of the jungle at the same time.
Did Trace see Wisdom? He might have just barely caught a glimpse of him.
Well, they saw him go in from the ward.
Oh, yeah,
in
they've
the
got
river.
One river.
So
yeah.
They knew he was there.
All right. Well, Trace has been staying safe, if nothing else. Shay does not hit that death sentence there.
Barely out of range, Prey.
He's Prey behind again.
Yeah, he is behind.
Not too far, though.
Captain Jack and Jay have had a lot of freedom, like you were saying, to push this up, since they have known that Wisdom is camping that top side of the map. Didn't really result in much of anything. Actually, Trace had to blow his flash at some point.
Wow.
Against Smeb. Looks like Smeb used the Gnar. We missed out on that one.
Ah, okay. Blame the Observer. Mid lane very even, though. Kuro keeping up quite well with Kuzan, and just not a lot of action in the early game.
Nope, but this is perfect for Ku. They don't want the action in the early game. That's where they lose skirmishing. They are not a good team when it comes to decision-making regarding skirmishing. If they can just play this defensive style and hit that mid-game, that's when their shock calling takes over and they have that chance to win.
Well, Wisdom just poking out Winged here, doing a lot of damage to him before backing off, using that chilling smite as well, too. And you know, it's not, he didn't need to kill Wing there. All he needs to do is do some damage, force him back, scare him, and that just lets Ku Tigers just get more vision into the enemy side of the jungle, too.
Yep. Very patient game.
Yeah,
Ku is getting all the information they need. They're winning the top lane handily. They have the Kog'Maw here just waiting to scale up. They've got the Victor Burst. They're in a perfectly fine situation. And Jhin Air going to have a late Rod of Ages this game, as we see Trace does not actually complete that item yet.
this rise is not going to be strong for a very, very long time.
Well, I hope Jhin Air is smarter and doesn't try and fight some early dragons like they did in their last match, because trying to fight with a rise in this condition just doesn't do you any favors, especially once Kog'Maw hits a power spike with the Trinity Force, picks up that item. No one on your team can withstand the poke, and Jhin Air, again, just doesn't have reliable engage.
Yeah.
In this game, when we talk about two teams that are much more interested in kiting or without that definitive person to engage consistently, it really comes down to who is in front of the dragon and Baron Pits first.
Yep.
Because if you're there, you are probably, well, not probably, you definitely have a very large advantage in that team fight, because the other team can't engage on you to stop you from doing that objective.
Oh, Kuzan's really done a good job of poking down this mid lane turret, apparently, too.
Yep.
We haven't seen a lot in the mid lane this game yet, but Kuro has been keeping up in CS, but not keeping up in turret damage.
I think this is why the Nashor's Tooth build is so good right now. It allows you to max Q first, even with the cooldown attack speed nerfs that came through. You don't have to go for the W immediately for the passive attack speed. And it's just so great against mid laners that don't have movement abilities or shields. You get a couple more autos in there, maybe, if you're lucky.
Yep, and Prey get a little bit more aggressive in this bottom lane. They've got the wards to do it with, and now that Prey is level 9, now he's got that Sheen, he can start to poke through that shield a bit easier.
Yes, he can. And a lot of wards going in from Gorilla around this dragon. They're one to take the Scuttle Crab.
They've had pretty much every Scuttle Crab this game, too.
Yeah.
Tiger's just, I mean, there hasn't been kills or a lot of ganks or anything like that, but they've really just controlled the map since minute one.
Well, it's smart of them to do. We saw them play a very methodical, oppressive style against KT in game two, where they snapped up all of those early objectives. We saw them have five dragons in that game in spite of the loss.
Yep.
And that's, Ku is great. And now this is Ku's time to shine. We're 16 minutes into the game. Trinity Force is done. This is where Ku, their shock calling starts to come alive. And I don't know about doing this dragon right now.
Oh, they're trying it. I mean, lucky for them, Ku Tigers are not around. Here comes Kog'Maw, though. Can he maybe poke people out? No, it doesn't look like it. They're going to go in on to Trace. Oh, Trace had a slash up. There's the ult from Smeb. The stun's chained, and that is easily going to be first blood taken by Wisdom here.
Not sure Wisdom needed to unburrow an auto for that one, but he does anyway. They react to the dragon with a kill on Ryze. Not concerned, I guess, with that first objective. They had wards that were cleared out, so they had to have some inkling that that might be a factor. And now Smeb seriously chipping out this tower. More than likely will get it on this wave. And Kuro just sitting in mid lane. His job is clearing, so that he can make sure that tower survives for a little bit longer.
Yeah. Kuro is a deceptively strong mid laner, because he always has early games like this, which is very slow, very methodical, very safe. But then late game, not many mid laners win as hard as Kuro does.
Well, Kuro also, to his credit, actually has the third most kills in this league at 171.
That's what I'm saying, man. When he gets rolling, the kills really start happening for this guy.
A lot of people, yeah,
bides his time.
Don't appreciate how much he contributes to the score lines,
yeah,
when it comes to kills for the Ku Tigers.
I mean, one of the big things is that the jungler for Ku Tigers, whether it's Wisdom or Hojin, just doesn't need to worry about the mid lane. You know, he doesn't really need to gank it. He doesn't really need to come save Kuro at all. He just can concentrate on top and bottom, and it does seem like junglers can have, like, the biggest impact in top lane right now anyway. So it's nice to be freed up for that.
Yeah, or just doing what Wisdom's doing this game, which is play a Bengi style of Rek'Sai and just play for vision the entire time. And maybe you get that first blood, which he did onto Ryze. Now, the Rod of Ages is done, but that is really, really late. 28 minutes, 27 minutes is what we're looking at for a fully stacked item right there, Smeb.
And try to hop
into a brush.
Yeah, do a little bit of damage to Wing. Gets kicked back in. Kuzan is there. Smeb in a lot of trouble. Will he get Meganar in time? Gonna be coming right now, but it's a little bit too late. There's a kill for Kuzan. And Smeb. Oh, Smeb. That was not safe at all.
Yeah, got caught in there. He didn't have his flash because he used it on the gank from the rise. And walking down the mid lane, Corus Kuzan has been pushing for most of this game, so did have the better angle to get into the river faster. Jack coming down into bottom with a completed Infinity Edge, so actually not going for the Avarice Blade that we see a lot of these Sivers go for to try and just get a little bit more gold in the early game. Trace maybe responding with a turret. This could be a huge turnaround for Jhin Air, but nope.
Yeah, teleport coming in, and they are all after Trace. Snap finds a ward. He's going to stop him immediately with the boomerang, but he can't quite stop the teleport.
Nope, doesn't have any hard CC in that mini Gnar form, so at least he blows Trace's TP, so they trade, and now there isn't a teleport advantage, and Captain Jack is going to respond with some quick autos. Already has those Berserker Greaves, so he can take it in this wave, staying even-ish. Pretty close in terms of gold.
Yeah, not bad at all.
But because Jhin Air was able to play so far forward in the lanes due to Wisdom's presence on the top side of the map and trying to get in the wards and then just put pressure on the rise, it has allowed Kuzan and Captain Jack to seriously chip these towers without fear. And that is now translating to some nice global gold that they're able to pick up.
Yeah, Ku Tiger's still just a little bit ahead in gold overall, probably partially because of that first blood and because of the farm in top lane.
But it's close. That farm in top lane, at least it hasn't gotten any bigger. It's held steady at 30. If Trace is behind, well, he probably should be in this early game on the rise. And now Prey and Gorilla forced to overextend, but they have plenty of vision around them to make sure that they are nice and safe. Lee Sin will be seen just killing some of the more forward tunnels on that side of the jungle.
Should be fine.
Not committing to anything more than that.
Minute 30 until Dragon is up again. And we'll see how dedicated Ku is going to be to taking this. They really want to push on this tier 1 first. That would certainly make the Dragon a bit safer. Wisdom already invading the enemy jungle, gets that red buff down. And will we see a bit of harassment onto Winged here?
If I'm Ku, I definitely want to fight this dragon. You want to bait. You know Jhin Air will fight with this rise, or at least they did versus Anarchy. And if you can get a team fight right now, you are going to be in great shape.
Yeah, they're really aggressively controlling the wards right now around Dragon. They definitely seem like they want it.
Yeah, well, they should definitely attempt it. And if their dreams come true, Noah, Trace will walk down and try and fight it. And Jhin Air will overcommit just like they did in the Anarchy game when they played the Rise. And that'll be a solid timing for Ku to take a team fight and to keep this Rise down even further.
That's certainly possible. If they can take this tier 1 before Dragon comes up too, that would be huge.
That would be. They're a little bit nervous about the Lee Sin. They see him killing some tunnels now on the backside of the Dragon Pit. Trace is going to go get himself a nice little Grump.
Grump fight.
Grump Wars.
That's right. Grump Wars. The Grump strikes back.
I'd like to see two Grumps fight each other.
Would you? They'd just be like spitting poison at each other and just kind of hopping around awkwardly.
Hopping around very slowly. Yeah.
Sounds like Kog'Maw versus Kog'Maw Blind Kick, which we could actually see that this season, too.
Whose ults are whose?
That's right. Well, Dragon started by Ku Tigers. They had to let it lead. No, actually, they're still doing it.
They have an Aegis right now. They just finished that. This is a perfect, perfect time.
Can Wing steal this coming in? No, it doesn't look like it. So they very methodically take that Dragon and back off. Jhin Air, intelligently not fighting. They didn't overcommit to that.
No, they did not. They already got the first dragon with the rise. This was a major complaint of mine in their last match versus Anarchy, was that they were not playing well around that dragon, not playing around their timings. This time they decided to give it up because likely that team fight would have been a disaster for them.
Yeah.
Just get the farm instead. Keep farming up the rise. It's more valuable in the long haul. And nope. Grab will go over to Winged. Not going to get that. Wisdom was waiting for that crab, and Trace couldn't get it over the wall. it's due to the patience. Here we go.
Oh, they're going to go in on Wisdom here. There's a knockup. The double Smed comes down as well. Wisdom getting a bit low. Box used. Gorilla is there. Kuro is as well. He's fighting Wink in the back there. Smed gets out. So far, everybody's still alive here. Yeah, Jhinnir not wanting to commit to that one. This mid lane turret could go down very quickly, though.
Well, Victor is back. He doesn't have much mana, but at least Kog'Maw is there to help out with the wave clear. He really could have used some blue buff. They may just have to let this go.
Yeah.
Like you're saying, it's basically 1-0-W.
That's what I was saying. Kuzan could just walk up and drop a Sand Soldier on it, but he's not going to do it. Gorilla has that shield for now.
Wow, Maw of Malmortius finished first on Smed, just going absolutely nuts, but he's not able to stop the split push right now. That is, he was falling back all the way to his tier two, and if you're going to buy that item, you better be able to split push against this Ryze.
I mean, he's also got that Giant's Belt. He's also got the Warden's Mail. He's close to the Randuin's. We'll see how it works out, but I don't know. This game is like really on a knife's edge right now, you know?
It is, and to Jhinnir's credit, they've caught back up when it comes to gold. And the Ryze is starting to get scary. Well, it will be fully stacked on that Rod of Ages in the next couple of minutes.
Weirdly enough, this roster is looking genuinely tighter than what we've seen from the standard Jhinnir roster for the last couple of matches.
Abadoa. Let us wait and see what their team fighting looks like. It's essentially a different team.
That's always the question, yeah. So far, so good.
Ku just trying to get a little bit of an ambush in the mid lane. They're not going to find anything. Jhinnir backs off out of their opponent's jungle. They have a huge ring of wards around the Baron right now.
Yeah, they're going to have to protect that mid lane turret, though. Go down. Here's where the attack speed for Azir really helps as well, too. Oh, going in with a Chaos Storm. That was flash used by Kuro as well.
Yeah, nice aggressive play. Got two summoners out of Kuzan for that.
Yeah,
and they're going to get a tower, too. Now that the wave clear is gone, nicely played by Kuro.
Not bad. Truly a zoning ult. Whoa, and that was not the best place to use Fox. What? What in the world?
Jay is here to press R.
Oh, Jay.
Yeah, that was just a misclick right there.
Yeah, no kidding. That could be important, too. The thing is I don't think the Ku Tigers saw him use it, so they might not know that this ult is down.
Wow, and how huge is it that Ku actually got that mid lane turret down first, considering how low the HP is on their own tower. Now, they've had Gorilla there just to use that Janna E on it and get enough of that shield to dissuade Jhinnir from tanking any turret hits to try and get it down. Victor's back now. Victor does have the E, and there's an instant wave clear. He's got full mana. They're going to try and take away the blue buff right now so that Victor can't keep wave clearing.
Well, they should get it unless Kuro can steal it away, but he's not coming all the way down.
Well, okay, I don't know if getting this blue buff is worth losing the turret, though.
We will see.
Oh, he got it!
Wow, he was able to take it. Yeah, with the death ray.
Well, Wink didn't have smite up, but that was a nice job by Gorilla. And they're not even going to lose the turret for it either. Look at this. He's there to clear out the wave in the nick of time.
Man,
that went very
that
badly
die.
For Jhinnir. They would love to get this turret down before the actual dragon fight starts, because as long as it's up, it just stops that minion wave that much sooner. But props to Gorilla and Kuro for playing very well around holding this tower for as long as possible. The other nice thing is, even if they do get the gold later on, they're not going to be able to recall and actually spend it before the dragon comes up. So, great hold in the mid lane from Ku.
Bot lane was pushed for the moment, but Praise got the wave clear to just push it right back again, and that's helping him catch up in CS in a big way as well, too. He's finished his blade, too, so Praise is really ready to rumble at this point on this Kog'Maw.
Wow, I love this Captain Enchant early from Gorilla on his boots. Got the Magizer, of course, on the job.
Oh, that's a lot of damage on the Kuzan. Kuzan in a lot of trouble. He couldn't get over the wall. Gets out on the Lantern at the last moment, but that Ignite ticking, not quite enough. Box used again for Che. This time it slows up Wisdom, but here comes Smed. Che could be in a bit of trouble. Wisdom went through two walls of the box there. Death Ray barely missing Che, but there's a flash. And the kill for Smed gets kicked under the turret, though. They're going to change onto Wing, though. Wing did a lot of trouble. manages to cue his way over the wall to escape. Still a close call, though.
Came at a great time. We talk about Ku's shot calling. They look at the Dragon Timer. That's when they decide to go all in, and they make sure they get the kill. Kuzan actually messed up his Sand Soldier bending, so he didn't get into the river like he would have preferred, and had to take the Lantern out instead.
That was a big moment for the Ku Tigers. Keep in mind, again, their mid lane turret is still up, so now that they've got the Dragon Edge, now that they've got the kill edge, things could start to snowball pretty quick for the Ku Tigers.
Yes, yes they could. And let's take a look at this again. So Kuzan tries to, he messes up his combo right there. Tries to follow the soldier before it gets over the ledge. The Q from Victor followed him after his flash, but was just barely not enough to get the kill. In the meantime, Smeb just going to chase on through. Wing really doesn't want to kick Smeb here.
well, he's about to turn
Beganar. It's not really going to do a whole lot. It was for their team, and he gets chunked out, and then the dragon is taken by Ku. So everything going their way right now. They can start to make some more aggressive plays on the map. They have good warding in their own jungle. They need to start thinking about warding up this Baron just so Jhin'er doesn't have acute time to sneak it. Yeah. Trace is online now, has a fully stacked Rod, has a Seraph's Embrace. Looks like he may be building into, I would assume, an Abyssal. But we'll find out.
Smeb's got his cowl now, so at least he's getting a little bit of MR, and that compared with combined with the Aegis on Wisdom, helps at least. Helps a bit. And the Magi's on Gorilla, of course.
Of course.
Standard Janna.
I didn't get a chance to talk about the Captain enchantment. Well,
go for it.
Captain is great early game. What Gorilla has identified is that Jhin'er doesn't have a method of engaging. So as long as his team gets that speed boost while they're running towards him, he can just kite. Of course, that doubles down with Janna's passive and makes it so a team like Jhin'er that already has huge engage problems on this composition is that much less likely to be engaged on. Trace is going to have an insanely hard time dealing consistent damage in team fights.
Yeah. Ku Tigers, again, have done a great job of controlling vision this game as well, too. Altrace going in onto Smeb, doesn't hit that first Q. Connects with a couple other spells. Smeb has to be a bit careful.
He does.
Yeah. He's got some MMR, but not enough to handle that rise right now.
Yeah, that rise is getting dangerous. Just stay at length, push the wave forward. See if you can get any pot shots down, potentially onto a turret. That's about all he can do. As you can see, Smeb is playing a little bit more reserved. Captain Jack finally found a time.
He lives for like 10 minutes, though.
He uses his auto reset to get the last two hits with the ricochet. Yeah. And finally, Gorilla, who has done such an amazing job of stalling out that mid lane push, makes it work.
Had to happen eventually. It survived a lot longer than mid turrets would normally. And I thought maybe Ku was going to go in on that. That was potentially a good engage.
Well, remember, Ku doesn't really have engage either. That's the problem.
They were just going through a choke right there, though.
Yeah. Ku, what they want is to force these kind of fights.
Yeah, teleport.
Perfect timing.
In. Baron going down very quickly, but they can turn off of it if they need to. They're sticking around with it. Here comes Jhin'er. They're missing a Zir, though. Kuzan's way out of the fight. Gorilla gets blown up completely, though. There's a kill for Captain Jack. Baron does go over to the Ku Tigers, though. Ray hops over the wall to escape. So they lost the support, but everybody else gets the Baron buff. That didn't turn out badly for Ku at all.
Nope, not at all. And this is what we talk about when we talk about Ku's shot calling. Great time to go ahead and do this Baron. They TP right when the Beganar is in full swing for Smeb. They're able just to go for that objective immediately. They have the damage coming down from Victor and Kog'Maw, and they know they want to snowball now. This is the time to go before you don't want to fight a six-item rise. Go for the kill now as fast as you can. You've got great siege here.
Well, Ku Tigers with their signature comp, more or less. See if they can get the win with it as Smeb pushes down the mid lane.
Now, 2-2 game.
He's got his Banshee's Veil now, too, which is pretty nice.
It's very nice. And we saw the same kind of game against KT. Very methodical, controlled from the Ku Tigers. They were so close to winning that one. They were controlling the Dragon, controlling the Baron, doing a great job. in that match, but they got overpowered at the end because they didn't have a lot of late game damage. Well, that is definitely not true here. They have Gnar, who's going to be ultra tanky, and then they have Victor and Kog'Maw. So yeah. Had they had this comp against KT, might have been a bit of a different story, but at the same time, they did get a lot of their advantages against KT from playing for the mid game.
Yeah.
The Rumble. So it's different philosophy.
This game is basically like, you know, two sumo wrestlers in the circle, right? And they're both like really pushing hard as even. And there we go. Prey gets caught by Trace. And that's an easy 1v1 despite the exhaust. Oops, Prey was pushed up a little bit too far, but
no wards for Prey on a split push. Yes. Gorilla was coming in. That exhaust was way too late to stop any of that damage. So Trace makes a big play.
That's a big mistake, too, by Prey to be that far up. That sumo wrestler that is Koo Tigers just tripped.
Tripped, fell right in the sand.
Yep. And the thing is, they've already got the Jin Air sumo wrestler pushed back, you know, a little ways towards that rope.
He's got to lift him up right there.
Yep.
By his belt.
Well, that's what Rek'Sai does. Pumps you right up. And have they caught Wisdom here? They use that Sivir ult. There's a play. The box of Jay's going to flash. Tumbles under the wall. Smeb's like, nope, I don't want to get it. Nice! Death sentence. Wisdom still gets the knockup, still alive for now. Another play from Jay. Gets kicked out, and he lives. He just barely lives.
Gorilla coming in with the shield on Janna actually helps him live. They invested a lot in that little gank.
Yes, they did. And Rek'Sai coming right back in. He's got the home guard, I believe, and there's Meganar. Can they catch someone, maybe? The building's spell shielded by Captain Jack. And Dragon up now. So this all happened right when the Dragon spawned as well, too. So Koo Tigers trying to muscle their way into the river right now, and it looks like they're able to. They've got Trace a little bit cut off from the rest of their team.
He's in a bit of a rough situation, but they have the position. They have the priority onto the Dragon right now. Jin Air wants to fight for number two.
Yeah, well, Koo Tigers pulling the Dragon away. It's going to be more or less a 50-50. Smeb getting poked pretty hard, though, by Kuzan. They have to be careful with that. They may just need to give this one up to Jin Air. We'll see. I don't think they want to do it. Comes in. Lee Sin gets it. Jin Air grabs that Dragon, and they get to disengage before any fight starts. So very close, but they tied it up, and this game is extremely close still.
Well, all that hope that the Koo Tigers had of trying to use that Baron was dashed when Prey died. They needed him for the siege with the Baron buff.
Yeah, that really did kind of kill the Baron buff. They're going to try to take up this tier 2 now. Gorilla got poked very heavily, winged, trying to come from the side, and the Koo Tigers are going to have to back away.
What is that sound effect?
I was wondering the same thing. Because it sounded like the sound effect where Kog'Maw's about to die.
It sounds like Ikathian Surprise is on a loop in the background.
Oh, yeah,
it is.
Yep. Well, it's not much of a surprise now, is it?
So the game is bugged. Whenever we look at Kog'Maw, we are going to hear Ikathian Surprise.
Well, it's better than, I suppose it's better than the Corki.
The Red Baron Corki.
Yeah.
All right, well. A little bit interesting, but yep. There we go. And now Rek'Sai coming back in once again. So Koo couldn't push that advantage. They still will be powerful in the late game again against the Ryze and the lack of engage from Jin Air. Jin Air has to make a pick with a Thresh Hook, or Winged has to come up huge and kick Victor or Kog'Maw into them if they want to win this game late.
That's the idea. Captain Jack just passed 410 CS at 37 minutes. And you really got to wonder why we haven't seen as much Captain Jack, because Pilot's been good, but Captain Jack has had a lot of very good games this season as well.
Yeah, and when we look at Captain Jack, I would say generally, as promising as Pilot is as a rookie player this year, he still has some growth to do and some development to do, and Jack is just very stable.
Yeah. He's got that veteran mindset. He's got the fastest cleanses in League of Legends. This guy's never going to get caught with a spell if he's got a way to get out of it. And so it is surprising that they haven't stuck with the safer option, you know? Charge up the mid lane for Jin Air right now. See if the Koo Tigers can stop it. 50 seconds until this next Baron.
Yeah, there's no Victor. Victor busy getting
pulled up. They're going to catch Trace. Trace still very tanky. He's going to be able to get out. That's a lot of damage. He'll take Solander. No, he doesn't, actually. Caststorm comes in, turns onto Wisdom, and with only Kuro there, this is really dangerous. Goodbye, Wisdom. No, here comes the rest of Ku from the background. They take out Kuzan. Gorilla gets that kill, and now the Ku Tigers suddenly with a huge advantage. They could probably just walk up to Baron as soon as Wisdom got his health back. Oh, and Dragon's Rage used on a Smeb there, too.
Yeah, oh, just boy. To knock him back. They're going to take away the red buff, and now with the Baron up, it's a free Baron that Kuzan got flanked. They thought they had a good pick there onto Wisdom.
Looked like it for a second there.
Yeah, but the rest of the Ku Tigers just reacted immediately, walked down, and Kuzan was all by himself on the flank.
Well, here comes the Baron right now for the Ku Tigers, and it could not be at a better time.
TP.
Still 20 seconds left until Kuzan comes back. TP was used. Are they going to be able to poke Ku Tigers out of this? Che throwing hooks in. I don't know if it's enough. Smeb still very low. A bit tanky because that early Maw. They
he
do.
Got
oh,
it.
He stole a Baron. Wing was able to take it. Now Ku really needs to win a team fight here. They're chasing Captain Jack. They'll get him. The kill goes to Kuro. But a huge moment for Jin Air. They needed that steal so badly.
They did, and they tried to Monsoon Winged out of the pit.
It was close.
But
it was so
Winged
close.
Got in there, still had his flash, managed to win the smite duel, and that means another Baron attempt that Ku really could have used, but they mess it up one way or another, and it goes over to Jin Air.
Yeah.
Trace is getting scary.
Yes, he definitely is. He has a Void Staff, he has another needlessly large rod on top of everything, and they still have not even taken the bottom lane tier 1. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, Ku Tigers. And catching Captain Jack was nice, but it definitely wasn't enough to make the Ku Tigers feel comfortable here. Let's watch that one again.
Yeah, just watch the steal coming in. So Wing gets... Oh, they did
too
Monsoon.
Early.
The Monsoon was too early.
Oops.
That was not good.
Big mistake by Gorilla there.
And they... Kuro, you can see how much damage he is doing right now. Captain Jack finally gets a cowl, so that will help his survivability.
Well, this is just one of those games where positioning is going to be what makes or breaks this, right? I mean, because you've got both teams able to do pretty enormous burst damage, and so the first person to get out of position first is probably going to lose their team the game.
Yes. Yes, they are. And especially when we talk about the pick potential coming in from Jin Air and the relative lack of engage from both teams. Now, Jin Air is going to have Baron for the next dragon, so you have to believe that Ku is just going to give that one up. But these...
Dangerous to
man,
do that.
These That's... last couple of Barons could have been huge for Ku Tigers, but something goes wrong each time.
Now Gorilla coming in. Smeb wants to make a pick here.
GB.
They've caught Trace. They've caught Kuzan. Kuzan getting out of the wall. Back to the rest of his team. Wing's still in a little bit of trouble here. Looks like he'll be able to just make it back to the rest of the Jin Air Green Wings players. Now, teleport was used by Smeb to go in there. Now they have to try something here. Siege on this bot lane is looking like it stopped for now anyway. Wow, Smeb gets poked out hugely by Kuzan. It's a lot of damage coming in. There's a lot of AP that Smeb can't handle, apparently.
Yeah, he's going to go back. Has his Meganar now, so he will be tired for little bits.
Well, the dragon's up, so it's a bad time to not have Meganar.
Yes, yes it is. Now, would they fight it with four Baron buffs on the enemy team? I'm not sure about that.
Trace is really low, and he's not really near a dragon. He's kind of hanging around the outside. He's got a splash to get in if he needs to, but the fact that Trace doesn't have a lot of health may let Ku be a little bit more aggressive here.
Also no TP yet, so no way to get that health back and get right back into the fight. Jin Air. I'm going to start this one. Smeb backs off. He's just trying to get some rage off of the wolves.
Yeah, it's going to take a little bit too long. Maybe Ku Tigers coming in. Can they steal this dragon away? Whirlwind used. They're going to try to burst it down. Who's going to get it? Dragon taken again by Winged. He comes in and smites it away. What a series of plays by Winged here on these objectives. Stealing the Baron. Stealing away that dragon.
Well, he may not have had a good presence in the early game, Doa, but he is making up for it in terms of helping Jin Air with their objective control. Now, they're going to lose a tier 2 in the mid lane, but this game still incredibly close in terms of gold. And Ryze rapidly approaching six items, has that Rylai's picked it up a little bit ago, and that slow is going to be very useful if he can ever get onto somebody, but a flash should be enough.
We will see. Death Sentence doesn't connect. And Jhin'er pushing up that top lane. Ku had the advantage for the moment positioning-wise, but they had to back off immediately. Man, Winged is single-handedly saving this game for Jhin'er right now.
Yes, he is, and Trace too. If he had gotten that pick onto Prey, this could have been a very different game because really Ku with that first Baron, had they had the Kog'Maw, been able to group up.
Yeah.
But Trace came through with the solo pick to make it work. Smeb now with the Thorn Mail building into yet another MR item, probably a GA.
Yeah. Well, Prey really getting caught was the big turning point, and then the objectives being stolen have been more nails in the Ku Tiger's coffin for game number one here. And they're not quite dead yet. And Ku's on slow down. That's a lot of damage.
Goodbye.
And is he going to get away?
No!
Oh, he misses with the Q again. A nice play by Che. Che has saved so many people this game, too.
Wow. So right there, the Lantern at the last second. Smeb flashing, and he gets the Meganar. You have to wonder if he wasn't Meganar, would he have been able to connect with an auto to finish that kill?
I wonder. Looks like they might be able to get this bottom lane tier one finally. Baron up in a minute 30. Still a very close game. You know, we've talked about Wing, but Che has also been making a lot of great support plays as well, too. Pulling people out of there. They're going to go in with the Chilling Smite onto Trace. Will they be able to take it down? There's the Emperor's Divide. Che saves another one. Kuzan still very low. Gets out. Gets shielded as well, too. Big knock up on the Ku Tigers to delay them. And the Ku Tigers shipping out Jhin'er, but without that kill on Kuzan, the Baron still might be risky. It's still a minute away, though.
Yeah, you see those ricochets coming through. Captain Jack is very strong right now as a six-item Sivir, and they are going to back out and try and set up for this Baron instead. They don't want to push their luck right now.
Man, what a fencing match this game has been in the last half. Just little power plays by both sides, and people just barely escaping.
I'm just surprised that Jhin'er looks so cohesive with this entirely changed roster.
Oh, Sivir ult, they're going to try to go in on the Smeb here. Smeb in a lot of trouble. He's got no flash. He's got no summoners. Goes to the stun, hops into the Raptor Pit. It's not enough. Kuzan with a kill, and that is almost certainly going to be a Baron, which could certainly lead to a win here for Jhin'er.
Jhin'er can do this Baron so fast. They have Azir and Ryze. There's almost going to be no window here.
It'll be 40
for
seconds.
The Ku Tigers, especially with that Gnar dead. By the time he's up, he will have TP, but they're going to have to stall this.
They're going to have to stall it for 40 seconds as well, too, because when Baron pops up, that's how long it's going to be until Smeb comes back. It's a long time.
Such a long
time. To ask
time.
For a 4v5 stall at Baron.
I think Ku just has to go for this and try and fight 4v5.
I think so, too.
If they give it to this Baron, I think they just lose.
It certainly looks that way right now. And they've managed to stall Jhin'er for the moment anywhere. Gorilla is zoning a little bit with those whirlwinds. Baron's starting to take a lot of damage now. Ku Tigers, again, trying to do what they can with those ults. Gorilla gets caught! Gets taken out. Another kill for Kuzan. And right back onto the Baron they go. That is it. Ku can't fight this anymore. And Kuzan's Azir looks very good. There's an easy Baron. Wing not even needing to steal that one.
All right. Well, Ku says we're going to try and hold out here against another Baron. Jhin'er has not the greatest siege with Sivir and with Ryze.
Don't need it right now. Oh, Captain Jack takes a turret. Kuro could be in trouble. There's a nice kick from Wing. Another kill for Kuzan, and Jhin'er is about to roll to victory here, man. Without the mid laner, it's going to be pretty tough for the Ku Tiger to stop any of this.
Man, Ku just suffering from crucial picks.
Yep.
But credit to Jhin'er, they found the picks. That's what their comp could do. They got them, and they translated them into objectives.
Gotta be careful here. It's still a 3v5, but Kuzan is very, very low. It's been so close. They're going to try to get a lot of wisdom. That is a ton of damage and a nice death sentence to pick up another kill for Trace. Man. This is a completely different Jhin'er team. This is
a totally
different team. And I mean, literally, it's a totally different team. Only Trace,
yes.
The same as the last roster. And there's there's a matchup for the day. I guess the production crew is really ready for this one to be over, because it looks like it might be very, very soon. Low health members of Jhin'er all over the place, but I don't think Frey can poke him out enough. Smeb doing everything he can, but Winged, he's huge. And there goes the Nexus turrets. There goes the Nexus. Frey gets caught. And that's a win for Jhin Air, and a big win. They needed it.
And we've said it. If Jhin Air wants to go to the playoffs, they must win.
Yes.
So a 2-0 would be great. That would help them out immensely. It still relies on the fact that Najin has to play pretty poorly over their next two sets. Captain Jack, smile on his face. They may not have had the greatest engage, but with the couple of picks that they got onto Prey and onto Smeb, they were able to take objectives 5v4 and then roll to that win with a late game rise. And the Ku Tigers looking very disorganized when it came to playing around that mid game, which is typically their strength.
Yep.
They couldn't pull it together and create the pressure when they needed it most.
Well, this was just a Jhin Air that we had not seen.
The issue with Ku, though, is they have so many points. They have a good differential in their game, so they're not as much on the ropes as some of the other teams like Najin and Jhin Air. So Maokai and Kalista will be the first bans. Ku going with the Maokai once again. Twisted Fate banned against Jhin Air, a team even without GBM that you would think might like to use it. It has been central to a lot of their strategies recently.
Ryze banned already on the red side by Jhin Air, so just not wanting to give Smeb or Kuro a chance on that champion. And I wonder if the Elise is going to be the last ban here. There's the Rek'Sai ban. Certainly looks like Ku might be setting themselves up for an Elise pick here.
Yes, I would definitely agree with you. The question is, will Jhin Air let them have it? And if it goes through, or if it doesn't go through, will the Gragas be the first pick instead? They're going to ban the Annie, so almost certainly an Elise, we would assume.
Yeah, they could take the Gragas as well, too. But Elise will be the first pickup. She's just so strong right now. It's dangerous to avoid that pick if it's available.
So the Gnar being hovered over. Ku did take it in the first round of the draft on the red side. Looks like Jhin Air moving away from the, at least the rumble in tonight's match. They had that opportunity to take it, but instead they want to deny Smeb his Gnar, and they will perhaps get something a little bit more lane dominant. And Kuzan will return to that Azir. Champion worked out for him nicely in the last game.
Yeah, he had a very, very good game on that Azir, except when he tried to get over that one wall and messed up his combo. But aside from that, he really knew how to position his Sand Soldiers. He played very well overall.
Yes, and he did so much damage to that mid lane turret. Now, it was a testament to the Ku Tigers that that turret didn't go down earlier.
Yeah.
But he did his job there, and they just couldn't group up and finish off that kill. Oh, yes, Smeb, do it. Play that rumble into Gnar.
I would love to see the Riven into Gnar. That'd be awesome.
Now, Ku, their last win was in game one versus Najin. They did play that Yasuo. It's not going to be picked up. But we saw Gorilla get a Kennen ban in game one. Now, we don't really know where this is going. Obviously, it's a flex pick. Gorilla would be very good. It's a lane bully champion. If Ku wants to play this way in a 2v2, they will have that option to try and force out Captain Jack, because we saw Prey and Gorilla falling behind on that Kog'Maw in the early game.
Do you think the fact that Kalista's banned makes it more likely that this is a top lane Kennen?
Maybe a little bit, but remember that Najin likes to run Lucian Kennen a lot.
That's
and
true.
That's a very powerful lane, especially against a champion like Sivir right now.
Might be the Lee Sin again for Wing. And yeah, he's going to lock it in along with Sivir. So pretty similar comp to game number one so far, except for that Gnar from Jhin Air.
Yeah, not going to give them any more primary engage than they had last game.
Yeah.
However, so they're still... It's better with the Gnar, obviously. And Lucian Kennen would be my guess here for what they're going to go for. If they go for Kog'Maw, they have an incredible amount of poke in the laning phase.
Yeah, but really not much peel for this Kog'Maw. Frey would have to be even more kind of careful about his positioning. Yep, there's Lucian locked in. Makes a little bit more sense. Will we see that top lane Shen? Could be a support Shen as well, I suppose. It's probably going to be a top lane Shen.
Yeah, probably going to be a top lane Shen. So it will be the Lucian Kennen lane that we've seen so many times this in the second round robin from Najin. It really has worked out very well for them, for Najin. This is the first time we're seeing a non-Najin team play it.
be interesting. One final pick over for Jenner.
Now, Ku, we're in a very similar situation to last game. Where is the engage from these teams? They've got great pick potential with the Elise for Ku, and if they lock in the Thresh, like you said, almost identical composition to the last game. The only difference is Gnar instead of Ryze.
That's a big difference, too, when it comes to late-game damage. Obviously, Gnar is a nice big front line. He's a tank, but you're not going to have Trace just blowing prey up again if he finds him.
No, but you still have sufficient late-game damage here. Azir and Sivir will be just fine in this particular situation, and they're just going to lock that Thresh in again. Che delivered on it the last time, had a lot of those clutch lanterns.
Yeah, so, a lot of clutch flays, descendances, a lot of good picks from Che.
But Ku changing this dramatically. Ku wants to make plays in the early game. They want to go ahead and use...
Ooh.
It's possible we could see it.
Maybe. They could still switch it. They've got until 20 seconds, but we might see the Lushen bot lane.
Lushen.
Doesn't really work as well, does it?
I'm curious what they're going to do. I think it's a fun flex pick for the Ku Tigers, and Smeb has been very good on Kennen when we've seen him play it.
Yeah.
There we go.
Okay, there's the swap. All right. So we'll be that support Kennen for Gorilla then.
Nice fun little swap right there at 20 seconds. That is the latest you are allowed to do that. So making Jhinnair scramble a bit in the end.
Yeah, a bit of mind games coming in from the Ku Tigers, but I think it was pretty expected. I think Jhinnair would have been more surprised if they would have left it.
Yeah, and especially it just makes sense.
Yeah.
You want the Lucian to really get ahead in the laning phase. The Kennen is such a bully support without that mana. So, and this is a great matchup. Ku really wants the 2v2 here.
True enough. Now, if Shen ults in on Kennen, does Kennen become primary engage with that shield then?
You still have to have flash. That's the problem, is that there's no dash ability for Kennen. He gets sped up during his lightning rush, but...
All right. Makes sense. Well, here we go, guys. Can Ku tie it up? Let's get in the game and find out. Welcome once again to another match here on Champion Summer. Ku Tigers versus Jhinnair Greenwings, and Jhinnair with their modified, heavily modified roster is up one game on the Ku Tigers, and it was a close game. It was very small things that led to the victory for Jhinnair.
And to get back to the Kennen point that you were bringing up, Doa, so the reason why we usually don't consider Kennen a primary engage champion is if we look at how he could be stopped. He can get kicked out, he can get flayed out, he can get boxed out, he can get Emperors divided out of a team fight. So unless he has the flash, he's probably never going to land a big four-man splicing maelstrom.
Right.
And you really can't play your engage around flash because it's very transparent and it's a very long timer. And you may not even have it. You may have to flash out of the situation where you're going to die. So it's not great to rely on flash as a form of engage. Now, Jhinnair is in the similar situation, but Gnar jump with a Sivir ult is a little bit more reliable.
It is going to be tough to get in for Kennen because you've got Dragon's Rage from Lee Sin, you've got Emperor's Divide pushing him out from Azir, so... do you feel like maybe a Braum would have been a better choice here?
I think they just want to play for laning phase, Doa. I do think that Braum is still strong in the laning phase, but this is ultimate bully lane. They want to win hard in lane and try and snowball off of that.
I'll see if they're able to pull it off. Smash both junglers getting there. Starts at the Krugs. We start at the Krugs. That's how it works. Solo lane Thresh. Not too strong.
Yeah, not too strong. Captain Jack tried to go in, but they were zoned out immediately off the wave. He can't actually walk.
What?
And he's going to lose some XP. This is great for the Ku Tigers.
I was going to say, this is pretty much perfect for this Lucian Kennen lane to have a start like this. This is just icing on the cake at this point.
Jack did get a little experience, but we are going to have a bit of a pause right now. I think Jack took one of the Sentinels from the blue buff. I was not looking.
How dare he? Remake.
I was trying to explain Kennen, and I was not looking at the main map. I apologize.
Well, it was an interesting conversation anyway. It's fine. Yeah, you can see the animations from the upcoming Ku Tigers cartoon that's going to be airing here in Korea. That's going to be exciting. They all apparently drive giant robots that just look like themselves. They're just like bigger versions of their human selves.
Yeah, giant smeb.
The chest opens up and you just hop inside. It gets confusing when they switch robots, though. You don't really know who's who. You know?
That would be the lamest giant robot show ever. Just a giant version of you.
Yeah, yeah.
Who wants, like, I already drive myself as it is. That's normal for me, Doa. I already control something that looks like me.
It's an exception, you know. But this would be like robot you. So like your fingers would like fold down and there'd be like cannons in it and stuff.
Nah. I'd still like a better, you could more badass a looking, more badass looking robot. I like it stylized.
Are you saying you don't want to turn into a plane? If you were a transformer, what would your vehicle be?
What would my vehicle be?
Yeah, what vehicle would you turn into?
I don't know. I never thought about that.
My guess is like the car Cruella De Vil drove. I think that would be what you'd transform into. I'm pretty sure.
A Rolls Royce.
That's right. Like a really old one, though, you know?
An old Rolls Royce.
30s era.
I like that.
Yeah.
I'd take an old Aston Martin, too. That'd be
pretty
great. Oh,
that'd be cool. Yeah.
Like a 60s Aston Martin.
Yeah. I wouldn't mind that at all. I'd want to turn into like a logging truck so that I could have like one of those like grabbing frames, you know? Oh, a gank in the mid lane. Kuro could be in a lot of trouble. Has to burn that flash early. Q connects, and Kuro could just go down right here. Oh, it's so close. One auto attack away.
The Q saving him. Wings coming in for the level 2 cheese gank.
Yeah.
Wisdom following up right now, just helping him push out the wave so he can go back. But Kuro gets that shield, has to use both summoners.
So close.
To get out of there. And now they just want to get some more pressure on this mid lane so that Kuro's not going to lose a whole hell of a lot of XP.
You know, at least they got Kuzan's flash out of that too. So it's not like Kuzan gains an overwhelming advantage from it, but it is a little bit rough early on.
And look at this. Winged now coming. Winged. Either is
coming bot lane. Flash land a gorilla. He could be in a little bit of trouble. Dodges quite a bit. So
great dodge on the death sentence there with the flash and the Lucian dash. Yeah. And look at this. Jhinnir playing really well. Trace knows that the Elise is not at full HP. Could be down at that blue buff. Just goes to take a look. And that was a great gank by Winged again. They saw the Elise in the mid lane. He knew he had some time while they were pushed up on the bottom side and blows a flash for his trouble.
Trace and Smeb trading pretty heavily in this lane. I don't want to say it's Smeb there.
Smeb.
Man, he's Smeb.
Smeb is actually a better name than Smeb. It doesn't sound quite as disgusting.
Smeb is really one of the all-time worst names for League of Legends.
It just sounds gross.
It does. Why would you want to name yourself that? Smeb. Wisdom. Try to gank here. Jhinnir's done a good job of calling the aggression from Ku and responding with a bit of their own, but Trace, once that Meganar is gone, could be vulnerable here. He has his flash, though. He's being very, very careful about the Meganar.
Yeah, Meganar going to come through. Yeah. Pretty delayed gank from Wisdom. He's playing this very patiently.
Yeah,
they don't know where the Lee Sin is. They don't know where the Lee Sin is. That is the one concern right now. They have some good chain CC. If you can set up the taunt into the cocoon.
Here we go. They're coming
big
in.
Minion
Trace
wave.
Hopping away. There's a flash. Missed the taunt, though. Oh, and they miss the cocoon, too.
Trace is so hard to gank as
he
a
is.
Top laner.
Yeah. Very elusive.
So two flashes used, but nothing gained from Ku. Kuzan going to go ahead and pick up the first blue buff of this game. Remember that Winged went for the red, then the gank onto mid and bottom. So Kuzan picking up an early blue thanks to the fact that Lee Sin is his jungler. And Kuzan can still push in. They want to chip out that mid lane turret again. They played this matchup well in the last game. Kuro definitely on his back foot. And can they get this mid tower super early? Jhinnir looking for it.
I don't know. Kuzan was able to push it really aggressively last game. Still took him a while to get it down, but he was able to get a ton of damage done early on, and you'd think under different circumstances that turret would have fallen much, much quicker.
Yeah, well, it was a good defense, right, from the Janna to keep it alive. If the Janna hadn't been in the game, it definitely would have gone down sooner.
Pretty much.
But the wave clear from Victor and the Janna to shield the tower did work to keep it upright. No Janna this game is going to make that considerably harder. Early recall from both AD carries for a pickaxe. Jack,
Think Ward.
Not losing too much when it comes to CS, and Gorilla and Wisdom are going to be found out, like you said, by this Pink Ward.
No big secret, they're going to be able to take it out. Kuro's still getting poked pretty heavily, but again, standard stuff in this Victor Azir lane.
But coming back to the Ku Tigers, it's another composition that they have no engage with. Basically, it's Flash Taunt or Flash Ult from the cannon, or they land a cocoon.
So here's a question then. How do you make playing a composition with no primary engage okay?
You are gambling on the fact that you will get in front of Baron and Dragon and force the enemy to engage into you to stop you from getting something.
So it really relies on good positioning around objectives.
Yes. Getting there first.
Yeah.
Right? Having the priority on that objective.
And so that's why people getting caught and picked off on Ku is so devastating then, because without being a man down, you can never get that.
Yeah. And Ku here, they have good siege too. They have good zoning from Victor, and they have a ranged jungler that's usually very helpful for sieging down turrets, because there are so few ranged junglers in this game. So they can always kite out if they try. If someone, that's another way to get somebody to engage on you though, right?
Yeah.
It's just about setting up four objectives, and that's when a lack of primary engage can work. But it tends to either work really well or backfire horribly, because if you fall behind in lane and all of a sudden you can't get priority on objectives, then you're never going to be able to efficiently fight at a dragon or a baron. And that has a lot of problems. Now, Ku has thought about this and they've said, okay, we're going to, our strategy this game is to just win lane super hard with Kennen and Lucian, so that we will have on the bottom side of the map constant pressure, we'll take down your tower, we'll get priority on the dragon, and that's how we're going to win. So we'll see if they can do that.
They have been pretty successful at it so far. Not a huge, huge amount ahead, but still significant. And now that they have that level 6, Cullen can just push Jhin Air back even more and help Prey get some decent damage in on that turret.
Yep. It's starting to go down right now at 9 minutes into this one. It's going according to plan for the Ku Tigers. They haven't been able to deny that much CS, but at least they're getting the turret damage. Wisdom here looking for Kuzan. And I like this adaptation from Ku. They had this matchup last game. Now remember what Wisdom was doing. He was really focusing on that top lane and shutting down Ryze. So Kuzan got to push up like this for free and just kill the tower very, very quickly.
Yeah, Wisdom thinking about going in, but they didn't know where Winged was at the moment, so didn't want to try it. Actually, I believe they did see him walk through the jungle right before he got to mid, so that was probably why.
Yeah. But I like the fact that Wisdom is now trying to help Kuro in a tough early matchup so that they can keep their mid lane turret up, because Jhin Air, their strategy really hasn't changed a whole lot.
Yeah. Well, credit to Kuro, too. He's been able to keep up in CS both games with this Victor versus Azir. So at least not straight up losing. They're going to try to invade this blue. Here comes Winged. He's got Kuzan with him. Can they get it? And they just scare Wisdom and Kuro away. Are they going to try to take this blue back?
Now, Stand United is available for Shen if they want to actually fight this.
Trace came down.
Yeah, Trace is here. He had that lane pushed up, which he is going to have against Shen early.
Oh, they do catch Trace a little bit, but Wisdom gets poked out pretty hard. They're going to have to give up this blue buff. This is going to hurt Kuro.
Yeah, that
big time.
They had so much control over the choke points with the Azir Sand Soldiers once they got in there. So nice play, good invade, and this further plays into Jhin Air's strategy. Now they took away the blue buff. Victor's wave clear isn't going to be there. They can chip out that tower one more time.
Oh, speaking of chipping, Captain Jack gets stunned and nearly gets taken out. Had to use that summoner heal to stay alive, even with that shield from Thresh. Wow, that was a nice little play from Prey and Gorilla.
Yeah, that was extremely close, but with both summoners up, Captain Jack not likely to die, but this is the problem. Will they lose the turret? Because once the turret goes down, then the dragon stacking starts, and Ku is well on their way to a nice snowball.
Yeah, then Gorilla starts to roam a lot.
Yes.
And that is really scary to think about. Ku Tigers going for this dragon right away. They've got the lane pushed up, so why not?
Yeah, actually, this is the better call.
Yep.
Go for the dragon right now, because you want to start stacking that as early as possible. You're going to be able to come back for that turret whenever you want to, basically, because of the advantage that you've already built up out of this laning phase.
Well, yeah, in fact, having that dragon now makes it easier to be more aggressive on not just the bottom turret, but all the turrets.
Yep. And a little bit more damage. But also not the threat of giving it up. So I like that. I think that is definitely the better shot call than taking the tower first and then going for dragon number one, as long as in their overextension they don't die to a gank. That would be the one thing that would really make this bad. Kuzan getting his third blue buff of the game here before 12 minutes.
Wow.
They want to push. They're trying to answer this on a different part of the map. They know they can't stop the bottom from going down, but maybe they can get mid in response.
We'll see how aggressively they want to be with it. Rilla and Prey back in lane.
So much Lucian this week.
Yeah. Well, he seems to be a pretty strong pick again now.
Well, he's just so good in lane. That's the big aspect of him. He's not going to do as much damage as many other AD carries in the late game, but his early and mid game are so strong that if you can do things like this, bully out the other AD carry, well, then so many objectives open up to you. The world is your oyster.
Uh-oh. Gorilla gets grabbed. That's a lot of damage. Fresh coming in as well. He's going to pop the slicing maelstrom immediately. Stay alive. And Gorilla is fine. Not much damage dealt with that culling. A little bit of skirmishing in the river here. The bot lane turret goes down. Baron from Divide pushes Wisdom out. Kuro could finish him off. He does. First blood goes over to Wisdom at the last moment. The Winged makes it out. The W over to that ward, but that first blood taken by Ku Tigers is pretty vital.
Now, Jhin'Air had no business skirmishing in the river like that. Trace didn't have TP. Smeb had both globals available, and so could instantly turn that into a 3v2.
Kuzan didn't have Nash's Tooth yet, too, so he wasn't doing a whole lot of damage anyway.
Yeah, two upgrades onto the Hex Core already for the Victor, so has just a lot of damage and utility at this point. Just don't go for that. In the meantime, we may see them lose two towers at the same time. That is maybe a game-breaking play there from Jhin'Air. They could have just fallen back to the mid lane, but now all the work that they did to get Kuzan ahead has been erased.
And the funny thing is, this is already more of a lead in this game than we saw pretty much the entire other game between each team.
Yeah, it's a rough situation now. Jhin'Air can still, they're not out of it, obviously, but it undid about 15 minutes of work and preparation to lose that mid lane turret and the bot lane turret at the same time and get Kuzan killed, who they had so carefully stacked up these blue buffs on.
Oh, and Gorilla can still just be annoying in this top lane on that cannon.
Well, guess what? Trace, though, has a cowl, and now he has to deal with Prey. It's not a good situation, so here comes the attempt at a snowball from the Ku Tigers. If they can keep on knocking down these turrets, Sivir is going to be sent to answer Prey in lane, but that's not a good solution either.
Well, I mean, no solution is really a good solution at the moment for Jhin'Air as far as who's going to stop this Lucian Ken in lane. I mean, who are you going to send?
There's no Lucian solution.
That's right. No solution for Lucian. Lucian is the solution. We haven't seen the solution since the Sona Lucian bottom lane. That was the solution.
Oh, poor Sona.
Not a lot of Sona.
So bad.
Yeah.
So squishy.
Yep.
So easily destroyed.
So easy to play, but so squishy. Oh, well.
The old face roll support.
Got her ultimate skin right as she was knocked clean out of the meta. And already that lane pushed up the turret. It begins.
Does begin. Turrets, wards rather, going down inside the tri-brush. Smeb holding his own decently. It's much superior now that he has the... It's going to get scooped around by Trace.
Should have the ult back by the time Dragon comes up in a minute 30, so yeah, probably okay to use that.
Annoying too.
They got Wing, and here comes Gorilla with that slicing maelstrom, and Kuro just solos Kuzan on the outside of the fight. Wisdom comes in for the finishing blow onto Winged, and that is pretty much the opposite of what you want to have happen if you're Jhin'Air. This lead is starting to get blown wide open for the Ku Tigers.
Yeah, Wisdom just chaining the cocoon straight into Gorilla's slicing Maelstrom. Gorilla's not done. He has no ult, but he can still get a stun off.
This is what we talked about happening. When that bottom tier one went down, it just unleashed Gorilla to start making plays around the map.
Yep, meanwhile, Kuro just going to keep on pushing right here. Everything going Ku's way, so they win the laning phase hard. They're able to translate that into continuous strong pressure on the map. Three kills, three turrets now, and no response yet from Jhin Air.
Yeah.
That fight in the river was not a good decision from them. They gave up so much for that. They gave up the lane that they were doing quite well in.
You know, and credit to Ku Tigers, too. It was a situation where they took something that was relatively minor and made it something gigantic, too, because that little fight by itself wasn't big for either side. But what Ku was able to do because of it, how they were able to follow it up, gave them a pretty enormous lead.
Yeah, absolutely it did. That's their power at snowballing. And this is the Ku Tigers Prime, the mid game. Right now, they finish off that tier one in the top side with 30 seconds left. So you can see Lucian coming down right now. Smeb wants a chance to shop before he gets into a dragon fight. But Lucian here around the dragon right when it spawns. Gorilla going to chase Trace away.
Dragon is up. Jhin Air has position over it for the moment, but I don't think they can fight the Ku Tigers. Nice ward, nice pink ward there. They've got the speed shrine as well through the culling, pushing back Trace and Winged. Didn't do a ton of damage, but it did allow Ku Tigers to get in there, and they are going to start the dragon.
Yes, they are. Quite easy for them to take it. We see a lot of recalls. No contest will be had here at that objective. Still no kills, no turrets, and no dragons for Jhin Air. They have to be worried about getting perfect gamed at this stage.
Which would be pretty surprising after last game went, but I suppose, to be fair, last game was very, very close for the majority of it. You know?
It was. It was definitely close, and Jhin Air hasn't made that many errors, but when Ku picks for this lane-dominant style, that can sometimes result in these large snowballs forming early. If you make a minor mistake, it will prevent your growth into the late game with a composition like Jhin Air's.
Pretty much. Trey's doing what he can in the top lane, and he's a bit tanky now anyway. Here goes his year tour. And a minute until Dragon comes up. And that would be, or not Dragon, a Baron, but then that would be the very first Baron. But do you feel like Ku Tigers could already start to put a bit of pressure on that?
Yes. I think they might well do it. Well, it's not going to be a perfect game. Trace will find a turret at the top side as Smeb is busy farming wolves instead. So they get something that's an important start if they want to begin making a comeback. But Prey and Gorilla continuing their incessant pushing. Kuro here too. Wisdom just going to try and zone him out along the side of the turret. Maybe see if he can get a cocoon for a pick. That burst is definitely there. Gets the cocoon onto Jay.
Yep, that's right. That's a lot of damage onto Captain Jack, too, just from that death laser.
There's a lot of damage coming in from Ku. Prey doesn't have too many items quite yet, despite his CS advantage, but at least he has that finished Infinity Edge, so that is something that Captain Jack really can't contest with. And Kuro just back to wave clearing in the mid lane.
Pretty much.
It's hard for Ku to push this into tier two.
Wow. Yeah, they're still able to do a decent amount of damage and get some poke onto the turret.
I mean, it's a Zir Sivir. It's a huge amount of wave clear from Jhin Air.
Yeah.
So they have a comp that is good at stalling this out.
It doesn't seem like Smeb's quite able to go toe-to-toe with Trace just yet, so they don't have the split push option right now either.
Well, not. I mean, Trace just with that range auto attack makes it quite difficult for Shen to get in. And like you said, he's not there yet. Smeb decided to spend some money on a distortion enchantment. That's probably wise, considering that they really rely on his flash in these team fights. Trace building Black Cleaver after Cowl, though, so this is a very aggressive, split-pushing Gnar build. He's not going to be overly useful should a teamfight break out. Ku may want to think about at least pressuring the Baron, because if they can force a team fight with a Black Cleaver Gnar, they will be quite happy.
Isn't going Black Cleaver, I mean, it's kind of, you're between a rock and a hard place, right? Because by going Black Cleaver with Gnar, you're kind of giving up a better team fight. But you have something against a split push, whereas if you go for a tanky thing, you have a better team fight, but you give up
a
split push. Do you think it's better to prioritize stopping the split push right now?
I think at this point in time, it's hard to say.
Yeah, it's a tough choice.
It's a very tough choice at this juncture as to what you want to go for.
I mean, you have to commit to something, you know?
Yes,
you can't
yes,
do
you
both.
Do. Well, at least in the mid game before you can actually pull off some more armor. Of course, he is going to be really vulnerable to Prey in this early game as a result of his decision. But as long as he can keep the pressure on, he can keep Shen in a lane. So Jhin Air, it's a fine choice to make, but Jhin Air just has to play for wave clear and next to their turrets, and Trace has to be forward on the map trying to take out the outer ring. He already got one tower. He may get two soon. He's going to have to get out of there. Lucian doesn't have the vision to commit to tower auto attacks, but gets quite a bit of damage with those caster minions onto the turret.
Yeah. So far, that split push has more or less been stopped by Jhin Air, at least. Dragon coming up in minute 20, though, and with two dragons already for Ku, you have to wonder if prioritizing the team fight might have been a little bit better.
Well, maybe he can have some more tankiness. Uh-oh.
Oh, they caught Jay. Jay trying to get over the wall. The ignite. Kuro just flashes for that one. Pretty easy pick for the Ku Tigers, and that is not what you want to have happen right before the dragon. I suppose he will be up in time.
And two games in a row, we've seen the value of these picks. Before the objectives come through, Gorilla gets poked out, but they make it work. Have to burn the flash, like you said, onto Kuro for the follow-up Q.
Well, it was nice to get the kill, and they're still going to have everyone set up in time for the dragon. Prey all the way up in the top lane, though. You probably want to start to rotate down there pretty soon here.
Not before he gets this Krug.
Gotta get the Krug. He would cry without the Krug.
Probably would. Just burst into tears right in the booth.
It's true.
So get some wards down onto the Baron. They have a see what's in the back of the pit right now. They're obviously, Spem should be a little bit worried about this, and that's just annoying.
Yep. I saw in the most recent, or in the, I think it was a 5.14 patch, once they fixed the bug where Syndra could pick up the Baron and take him out of the pit.
I'm sad. I didn't ever even saw that.
I'm sad I never got to see that either, too. I read that. I'm like, oh, man, I missed. I really wanted to see that bug. I'm sure I could find it on YouTube. Sad we didn't get to see it here in Champions.
Throw the Baron at somebody.
That would be fun, yeah. Just, like, continuously throw it down the river and just have it, like, help you siege turrets. There's an easy dragon for Ku Tigers. I didn't expect Jhin Air to really try to stop that one anyway.
No, and now we're getting towards the moment of truth right now. The gold lead is developed enough that Ku can start threatening the Baron. They probably should, because without that Baron buff, Jhin Air's wave clear is just so good that I don't know if they can actually think about sieging a tier 2. So by forcing them to engage instead, you are, I think, playing a little bit more to the disadvantage of Jhin Air's composition, which will have a hard time getting onto your back line.
I guess we'll see. Trace still pushing this bottom lane, but Smeb's been able to at least hold the tier 1 anyway. He's got his Sunfire Cape, he's got his Spirit Visage now. But I still don't think you can fight that Gnar 1v1.
Looks like he is worried about that prospect for sure.
I would be too.
So just getting up some nice vision around the Baron right now. Ku Tigers can trade with the Gnar when he's in that Mega Gnar form, because he's not going to take percent HP damage.
Ooh.
Prey trying to set something up with a Culling. Interestingly, Prey, a player that normally builds Ghostblade on Lucian, just so he can have poke Cullings. Yeah, they should definitely do this.
Yeah, they started the Baron, but they backed off. They're trying to pull Jhin Air into an unfavorable spot right now, because they know they can win a team fight. Smeb just tangling with Trace here. Ooh, taking a lot of damage, actually. Gotta be careful here. There goes the turret. And Smeb, he's got his flash.
Oh, he messed up his boomerang.
Whoops.
He threw it short, so he didn't get the slow into the Meganar transformation. He may have been able to solo Smeb if that happened.
I was kind of thinking that after the turret went down. I was a bit worried for Smeb. It all turned out okay. And who's going to start that Baron again? Now, Trace is recalling right now. We'll see if he can TP in to help. They see people coming in to try, but that Baron's getting lower and lower, down to about a third health right now. They have to disengage, though.
Okay.
They may have been able to stay in and finish it, but with all the poke coming in from Kuzan, that might have been a bit too risky.
Well, Wisdom just isn't that tanky yet, so they don't have a good tank there. I thought that the Shen was just going to ult in on top of Wisdom, and they could have finished that off.
I would think so, yeah.
Jhin'er had enough presence around that Baron to scare them, and they just keep on split pushing with this Shen. And I think if you want to split push on this Shen against this Gnar, maybe Trinity Force is something you need. I suppose he's just happy to wait out, try and be tanky. He is slightly ahead when it comes to gold.
Yeah, slightly. Two Tigers getting some more wards around Baron again. Kuro's able to get this blue buff. And how long will Jhin'er be able to prevent Ku from taking that Baron? That's the question. Battle over the Krugs. Oh, Trace wins. You got that Krug?
It's a scintillating, just riveting
Krug
action
commander
in this bottom lane.
That's right. Battle over the Krug. Baron fights? Who needs those? We've got two top laners fighting over a Krug.
Ku should just repeatedly bait this Baron. They have total dominance over this objective. They just need to keep on going back into the pit. See if they can maybe set up a pick within Elise Cocoon.
They seem a bit worried, though, you know? They do seem a bit apprehensive.
Well, after what happened to Baron last game, who can blame them?
That's true. That's a good point. And Winged able to still keep throwing wards into that Baron pit. They're cleared out. That is so annoying. Oh, here we go. Slicing Maelstrom coming in. Where's the follow-up? Calling over the wall. Here comes Wisdom as well. Can he get the cocoon onto Wing? He can't. There's a kick. Kuro still managed to get the kill onto Che. And that may be all Ku needed, because they really didn't lose a lot of health during that fight.
And Kuro didn't have to use Chaos Storm either. So that is still available for any fight that could be coming up. Trace does have his Gnar ult.
Well, Gorilla Zoning, got really, really hurt by Kuzan. Ku turning around onto the Rift Sculler, getting some wards as well, too. And can they catch Trace here? I wonder. Taunting in, they're going to try it. Trace, they pop the Banshee's Veil. Where's the cocoon? Wisdom doesn't quite have the cooldown just yet. There it goes. They catch him at max range, and Trace could be in trouble despite the tankiness. Never mind. Kuzan over the wall just straight up kills Gorilla, and now they've got Smeb a little bit locked down as well, too. Jhin'er pushing Ku right out of the river. That was such a big commitment to chase this tanky Gnar, and I don't know about that.
You just don't have good initiation here. That's the issue. They also stacked their CCs. The Taunt and the Cocoon were active at the same time. So they had a very short window to actually burst down this Gnar, and Trace comes in. A bit of a counter initiation, but that doesn't actually help. And see the TP will dissuade Jhin'er from pushing forward any further. But again, this is a little bit of a sticky situation for both teams, since nobody has that reliable method of initiating.
Yeah, when we really did see it come down to picks last game, so you really can't blame Ku Tigers for pursuing that as much as they did, because they know in a situation like this just how valuable taking out even one person can be.
Yeah, as long as you don't lose one in response. But you can see Ku know that the engage is a problem.
Yeah.
They have distortion enchantments on both Kennen and Shen, so they're maximizing their flash uptime.
Jhin'er starts the dragon. Ku Tiger's coming in. Gorilla's a little bit out of position, but he should be able to come up from the bottom. They could get a flank here with Gorilla. Kuzan's looking for him, though. Dragon getting a bit low, and there's a zoning for Kuzan to keep Gorilla away, from keeping from slicing Maelstrom behind. The Dragon getting lower, he's going to get it, calling Yuuzhan. They're going to come in. Dragon gets taken by Winged. He got it again. Ku Tigers couldn't stop it. Will they win the fight, though? Wisdom very, very low. A kill for Kuzan. And Ku Tiger's on the run already. Jinair could keep chasing this. Gorilla and Smed both very low. The Q dodged by Gorilla. Wing comes in. Can he land a Q maybe? Not quite. They do need to worry about Kuro. He's got a lot of damage he could turn around and put down onto Jinair, but this is going to maybe cost him a Baron. Maybe.
Well, Winged has been such a hero.
He really has.
Tonight. That would have been number four for Ku Tigers with the possibility of a 37-minute fifth dragon. Now Ku locked up for another 6 minutes. They really, really wanted to snowball off that objective.
You apparently just can't go for 50-50s with Wing. This guy just has something about him that lets him take it nearly every time.
It's been impressive to see his smiting abilities this evening. A little bit lucky, but obviously some skill involved there too. And the Banner of Command now done for Gorilla.
Wisdom Tiger special.
Yeah, Wisdom didn't have an Aegis. Aegis not particularly great this game, and you don't really need Lock-in Jinair against Jinair, I don't think, but this Banner of Command, they want to keep split pushing and try and play the map better than Jinair.
That should help out a little bit. Obviously, Kuzan's not going to be able to take out a bannered minion very easily.
No.
He's a lot of their anti-siege.
No, he's not. And now this makes this Baron doubly important. You have the banner, you have a really great siege.
Yeah.
Naturally in your composition, and the banner is maybe the ticket to grouping against Jinair's wave clear.
Certainly could be. Here we go. Bannered cannon minion coming in. Culling used a lot of damage onto Captain Jack, actually.
I don't know why you would use it right there. That's
a little bit
terrible.
Odd. Gorilla pops that slicing maelstrom. They get the stun onto Wing, but here comes the rest of Jinair turning around. Lots of damage onto Trace. He's still not that tanky in certain situations. Disc of the Sun goes up, though, and that's going to give Jinair a pretty good position to avoid any re-engagement by the Ku Tigers.
No one can engage this game.
Yeah.
That's why we see these very inconclusive team fights happening, is that there's insufficient engage. Smeb is able to port defensively to save members of his team, like we saw, and maintain that split push, but Trace still doesn't have his TP up, so I think that Ku, a little bit of a mistake to commit right there. Instead, go for the split push and set it up better. And there was no reason to use the Banner of Command right there.
Yeah. I mean,
it's just better to use it in the side lane, frankly. Split them up as best as you can.
I think that they thought maybe they could finish off the turret because it had already taken a little bit of damage. Didn't end up working out, though. Either way, the Ku Tigers have some time to sort of play around here before the next objective comes up. If anyone tries to take Baron, Kuzan going after Gorilla here.
Yeah, has that sorcery elixir, so Gorilla needs to be incredibly careful.
Yeah, he's very, very squishy.
And are we going back into Baron vision time from the Ku Tigers?
Probably.
Super push available now for Trace. His TP has gotten back up.
Man, if there's one thing Ku Tigers have been good at in this series, it's keeping their tier 1 and mid alive.
It's impressive, actually.
Does not go down easily, does it?
It hasn't gone down before 30 minutes in either of these games.
Yeah. Catch on to Che. Che taking a lot of damage, pops that box, flashes over the wall, but the repel will help Wisdom avoid it, too. Guys with the death sentence, a lot of damage onto Kuro. Kuro gets taken out by Captain Jack. A kill in return for Wisdom onto the support, but Trace trying to come in from behind with the flank. Wisdom on the run now already. Kuro turning around. There's another kill for Wisdom. Ku Tigers need to be careful, but it's gone okay so far. It's a 2-for-1 in favor of Jinair, actually. Wisdom on the receiving end of that last kill.
Trace tired now, not going to be in that Mega Gnar form for a little bit.
And they've got the man advantage, though.
Jinair really can't do anything about that. There's not an objective they will be comfortable taking. It'd be dangerous to do that Baron, even though they only lost their support. Winged is rather quite low after that tussle, but we did see both TPs used. Now, we'll have to see whether that TP used by Trace was worth the price of an extra kill going over to Jinair. Because it very well could be. Now Smeb is really unleashed on the map. Once he gets his Stand United back up, that could be a very nice timing for the Ku Tigers, and perhaps worth it because they didn't lose a dragon, they didn't lose a Baron as a result of trading one for two. And now you see bannered minions starting to be quite annoying in this split push.
Let's recall an award. There we go. They got it. Dragon in 45 seconds. Jhenair really could use their second. And again, if Ku Tigers gets the fourth, man, like, really any big significant objective taker team fight right now is probably what either one of these teams is going to need to push the advantage with the game.
Yeah, Prey taking a bit of damage from the Baron.
Yeah, you can sustain back up.
It is quite close, as you're saying, Doa. The problematic part is that Trace still doesn't have that many tank stats. He's trying to get his Rando and Ullman right now.
We saw Trace just get blown up in that last fight. He nearly died.
Yeah, he's simply not tanky yet.
Yep.
Black Cleaver taking a lot of his money, especially compared to Smebs. Shen already completing three full tank items.
Gold's very even, though, between those two top laners, and Trace should have his Randuins pretty soon.
Yes, he should, but this is the right play from Ku. Use the split push while you still have it. Don't overcommit to the Baron or to a kill like you did last time. Just let Shen go to work on the side lane. You go for Shen, then you lose the Baron if you are Jhenair.
Well, they've sent a couple people after him so far. Kuzan is there. They are going for the Baron. Ku Tigers taking the opportunity. Wing is there, zoned by Gorilla just a little bit. Pops that slicing Maelstrom, but they're going to go in on him. Oh boy, this is going to be really, really close. Gorilla's still alive for now. They're going to get Wing. Maybe Baron taken by the Ku Tigers, and that's all they need. They don't need to chase that kill. Kuzan with a lot of damage, but Gorilla gets out anyway, and that is it. That's exactly what the Ku Tigers needed.
Very good call from Ku.
They
put a minion wave, they slow push it all the way from their own side of the map with the Shen, set up the play. As soon as they see Gnar, they instantly commit to the Baron.
That leads to a fourth dragon as well.
Yeah, I love Smeb's TP there too, or his Stand United. He could have chosen to go onto Wisdom and tried to mitigate some of the Baron damage, but they see Winged. He instead chooses to get onto Gorilla, and they just chain their CC together incredibly well to lock up Wing, who's been very successful at stealing some of these objectives tonight. Wing never even gets a chance to get into that pit.
Yeah.
And they secure a Baron. Nicely done by Ku.
You know, this adaptation to change over to Kennen really is good, too, to prevent Wing from getting in for those kinds of steals, because he comes in, you're just slicing Maelstrom, and you should be able to get a stun long enough to prevent the steal.
Yes, and that was the major objective. So now Ku maybe finally have minion waves big enough to help deal with this situation of high wave clear from Jhenair. They have their TP up now, so Smeb's still the one safer in the split push.
Should be for now. Meanwhile, we have Kuro pushing up the bottom lane as well. And here's where that Banner of Command is going to come in really handy, too. If you can banner a Baron cannon minion, that is very hard to deal with.
Yeah, Jack is going to have to be the one to deal with that situation. Banner is still down.
Yeah, with a short range for Sivir, too. That's pretty tough. Banner should be up pretty soon by Gorilla, I believe.
Yeah, it should be up in about, say, 20 more seconds.
Okay.
They're going to have to wait just a little bit, but they will get one shot at a bannered cannon minion during their push here with the Baron buff.
Yep. Now pushing all three lanes right now. Everything pushed up. Yep. There's that Bannered cannon minion. He's huge. Does a lot of damage to that turret, too. Wow. And it's so hard to deal with that.
So many boomerang blades you need.
Yeah.
And you have to walk far forward, then you're susceptible to Victor Poke. I don't really want to be in that situation.
That
so.
Banner of Command, like we said, it's really the Ku Tigers special here. It's taking so long.
It's incredibly annoying. Cully not really going to hit anybody, but they get the minion wave in and the tower. Nicely played on the siege.
Yeah.
Ku finally following through with their win conditions after being a bit denied in game number one.
There's the inhibitor, too. Nice dodge for Wisdom. Getting out of the way of that death sentence. Smeb's still split pushing.
Yeah, why not? Just go ahead, meet him on that top side. You want the last tier two right now. Maximize your gold lead.
Oh, Gorilla has Righteous Glory as well, so getting more tankiness.
Really a necessary item on support cannon. You have to find more ways to be able to get in there that aren't so flash reliant.
Yeah. More gate, more tankiness. And this turret taking a lot of damage. Well, Wing trying to make a big play. Kicks Prey the wrong way, though. Slicing Maelstrom used immediately. Trace getting very low. Still not that tanky. Jay gets blown up before he barely gets out. And Kuzan doing a ton of AoE damage. Or not Kuzan, Kuro. And I'm actually shocked that Jin Air didn't lose a lot more people right there. They lost to Tier 2, though, and that's the important thing for Ku Tigers.
And they're going to keep pushing, even though they don't have the Baron buff anymore. Everyone is back, so they get a tower for free right now while the enemy team is healing. Smeb has his TP. He is...
going to be an inhibitor, too.
Yeah, just came in. Yep. So that was nicely done. Ku, man, Smeb hit a gorgeous taunt underneath that turret to set up the damage for Kuro.
It was literally like a half second of AoE damage from Kuro away from that being like four kills for four.
That could have been the end of the game. That definitely could have been the end of the game right there. It was, like you say, extremely close, but a great Baron from Ku. They take so much.
Yeah.
Several towers, three turrets, two inhibitors. Killer 2, and they set themselves up for a fifth dragon in about 3 minutes if they want it.
The Ku Tigers have done a good job of targeting and blowing up the right people, too. You know, even if they're not getting the kills, they reduce the health of the people that can make the difference, right?
Yeah, and that's how Prey plays Lucian. He's not a big teamfight culling guy. He will almost always pop it first to poke someone off of an objective.
It's almost like kind of Neo Caitlyn in the way that you use your ult just to soften up the enemy team to help pick a tower or win a team fight or something early.
And that's how we used to see him play it too, when he built Ghostblade as a second item. Of course, just popping the active during the ultimate so you get that many more projectiles during the culling. Yeah. And just using it for poke. And then he has the Ghostblade too, which is very good at killing towers.
Speaking of killing towers, who wants to take the last inhibitor turret here in the mid lane? And we'll see if Jin Air can stop them. No Baron buff anymore, so they're just purely going off the strength of their team at this point.
And the fifth dragon. Quite conveniently placed super minions. They're just going to hold here. They're just trying to keep Jin Air from getting wards in so that they can get this fifth dragon in as much safety as possible. Smart of them just to wait right now. Just stay back. Force Jin Air to try and go on to you, because otherwise you just win the game with five dragons.
Prey trying to push in with the culling. Oh, he got way too close there, but I guess it wasn't so bad with Kuro picking up a kill on the Kuzan. That was a bit lucky by Prey there.
I'm very surprised they chose to play this aggressively. They only just had to sit out there on the side. No need to take a risk like that.
It's about making a statement, man. It's about sending a message, and the message is, we've got all your inhibitors down. We want to win the game.
Well, that message is resounding in this particular game.
Oh, Prey has to cleanse out of that one. Smeb uses his ult. Operation Keep Prey Safe is successful so far, despite Prey's best efforts. Wing taking a lot of damage here, and all these super minion waves coming in. It's going to be tough for Jin Air to hold this one off. Prey's trying to get in the back lines for some sort of a play with Gnar, but he's got no Mega Gnar anytime soon. Now building up to it. Smeb goes into the back lines a little bit. They're going to get Captain Jack immediately. There's a kill for Prey. And Wisdom trying to assassinate him. Whoa, that was a Gnar ult that almost threw Ku Tigers right into the fountain. Not quite close enough. That would have been pretty hilarious, but Kuro able to get the kill there, and there goes the Nexus. Ku Tigers tie it up with a pretty convincing game number two.
Yep, and they kept Jin Air down, away from turrets, away from kills early. I really liked how they used the Lucian cannon lane to start getting an advantage, and then swapping around the map. They stack up the dragons, and they make it work that time. Just methodical play from Ku. Not too many mistakes. We didn't see that same punishment from Jin Air. They couldn't catch people out from the Ku Tigers at the right times like they could in game one.
Yeah. A couple close calls here and there, but Ku Tigers seem to have a better response to Wing, first of all, with that cannon, and just played a little bit safer, you know, didn't give those pick opportunities over to Jin Air, and were able to swing enough objectives to a good lead.
Depends on what happens there.
Yeah. We might see him again, even if they lose out today, but it all depends on this game. Game number three, picks and bans between Ku Tigers and Jin Air. What are those bans going to be? There's a Maokai ban, first off.
Yep, banned every single game this series by the Ku Tigers. I think we're going to see the TF, and will they ban the Rek'Sai again? Try and first pick at least, I'm not sure. They'll save that Rek'Sai until their final ban, but I think the TF is necessary, and that is going to come through. So yep. Annie will be banned. Question is, well, I assume the Kalista ban would come in last from Jin Air, but actually taken out here by Ku.
Huh. So that gives Jin Air the option to perhaps ban the Victor or ban the Elise?
You would think so, right? You think that they may be banning the Elise right here, but that would give Ku the Victor. I think if you're Jhin'er, you leave them both up. So ban the Kennen, smart.
Yeah, because if you ban one of them, then you give Ku the other one. So just taking that Kennen away.
Remember that Jhin'er banned Kennen and Annie and Braum in the first game of this series. So they know that Gorilla is the major threat to the early game. I think this is a smart drafting choice from Jhin'er.
And of course you take away that Victor. That's a given. But what else do you go with? Winged Lee Sin looked very good, and without the Annie or the Kennen to worry about, theoretically you could do okay. But you just take maybe the Thresh here.
I don't think they want to show their duo lane, considering they lost lane hard last time.
Oh,
any aspect of it.
If they pick the Lee Sin, does Ku just take Thresh in response?
Possibly. I don't know what their plan is going to be. Do they have another support that they want to play with the Lucian?
Maybe. Braum is still up.
Yeah, the Braum is available. You'd have to think that's what they're looking at. They could go Cog Braum.
Yeah, and so Ku obviously prepared for this Victor pick. I mean, they took Elise and they knew they'd be giving up the Victor to GBM. Is Yasuo the answer? I don't know.
Yeah, this you can block, of course, the Death Ray from Victor if you so choose, but there's no need to take your mid laner so early. They could go with a knock-up composition. I think you take the Gnar here. We saw that be the preferential strategy for Ku.
Yeah, they will. They'll grab the Janna as well. So I think they really, really want Jhin'er to be thinking Yasuo. They really hovered over it quite suspiciously. But is it mind games, or is it truly the intention of Ku Tigers to pick it up?
I don't know. It would be good for the laning phase against Victor, but unless you can blow him up in the late game. When we saw Ku play Yasuo previously, they were playing champions like Gragas and Alistar alongside him. Of course, the displacement from the Janna ult will help you land that last breath. Same thing with the Gnar scoop, I believe. Yeah, that should trigger Yasuo ult too.
Does it? It's not, because it's not a knockup technically, is it?
No, but displacements do. Okay. I actually don't know the answer to that.
Twitter, take the wheel.
So that would be...
Jugger Vein?
The Jugger Vein coming back. That did happen yesterday. SK Telecom ran it quite successfully, in fact. But with the Victor already picked, unless you're going to play that Vein at support or in top, something we really don't see very frequently, that's not going to be the answer. Pilot going back to the Vein. So he's in the game. They want him to hard carry. He doesn't have a lot of peel yet. I would think that Trace needs to play something tanky and with wave clear. Or he could go for a rumble and just try and play aggressively in the early game. And
they've got good peel for poking, I suppose, too, with this.
And Prey locking in his Corki, his most played champion in his career, and the Azir for Kuro. So the Azir will change hands over to the Ku Tigers. We saw Kuzan do a good job on that champion previously.
Oh, and are we going to see this top lane Lulu? Oh, we will for Trace.
First time in a long time that we've seen a top lane Lulu in champions, but Trace wants something with wave clear. That was one of the issues that I said needed to be addressed, and he will be able to answer the ranged auto attack of the Gnar. So has the wave clear, has the ability to trade blow for blow at range, but again for Jhin'er, they lack engage. They're playing around the Vein very heavily, but they're playing for kiting with the Lulu and the Thresh and the Lee Sin. Other side, Ku, same story. We haven't had really a primary engaged champion in this series so far.
Do you think that's indicative of where the meta's going in Korea, or is this kind of an aberration?
I think that both Ku and Jhin'er really like to play kiting comps. That's what I think, Doa. They
aren't the most aggressive teams early, are they? Yeah, they just like to play along. Well, there's the roster. And again, Jhin'er absolutely needs to win this game if they want to keep their champion summer dream alive. If they lose, they're out. No more hopes for playoffs.
And at the same time, Ku Tigers, this game is very important to them. They could skip an entire best of three in the playoffs by not ending up in fourth and fifth. They're still competitive for the second and third seeds. They gotta win.
That's right. So a must win for both games. Ku versus Jhin'er. Let's get into it and see who takes the series. And we are back. Welcome to Ku Tigers versus Jin Air Game 3. Fans really getting into it now, and everyone at home should be too, because this is a very important series late in the season here for both teams.
Yeah, and at the end of the night, if...
That is a raccoon, not a tiger. No, you've got that animal totally wrong.
Maybe it's the raccoons?
Raccoon tigers? I don't know if that works. Oh, Kyuan to Wisdom, a little bit early. Harassment from Jin Air as they move in for some deep wards.
Yep, just getting an early invade here. No doubt they are thinking about possibly lane swapping the Vayne against the Janna Corki. Just trying to scale up, and because Lulu does quite well in these 1v2 situations, we'll see if they get any kind of information whatsoever from their swath of wards placed into the topside jungle from Ku. Prey and Gorilla hovering around that mid lane right now. They got some deep wards in too. Let's take a look at Pilot on that Vayne. He will be actually seen right there walking into or around the bottom side.
It's a lot of pings going down.
Yeah, it's a lot of where is the duo lane going?
Yeah.
So the hand has been revealed. Prey and Gorilla just sticking around in the mid lane until they see where Pilot goes. They are going to meet each other in the bottom side.
So we'll be that 2v2. And we'll see how much Prey and Gorilla can harass early on here.
Yep, Prey and Gorilla really wanted this. This is their choice in this game.
Yep.
Jin Air not able to dodge this out. Should be pretty farm centric up in the top lane. Obviously not a tremendous amount of kill pressure onto Lulu ever in a solo lane. Has great control of the wave, great trading potential, and once she hits six, well, good luck killing her.
Yeah, and even before that, you've got the whimsy, you've got shields, you've got slows. Lulu has a lot of escape options.
Yes she does. So again, both of these teams really focusing on kiting and disengage in this game. Each team has a method of setting up a pick, whether it's a cocoon from Elise or a hook from Thresh. But we may be in for another long one.
Well, we may be in for a fight in the bottom lane here as Prey gets very low. There's a flash from Pilot. Can he actually take him out? He can! First blood goes over to Che, though.
Wow, I have no idea what happened there. Looks like Che managed to find a flay early on to Prey.
I think you got a two-man flay there, and that messed things up. And it may have been like right after a whirlwind was used by Gorilla or something.
Wow, that is huge. Getting this Vayne rolling early. Ku wanted this lane matchup, and they immediately give up first blood. Without even a gank, that is a terrible misplay by the Ku Tigers, and a great start to a game that Jin Air must win to keep their playoff hopes alive.
Yeah. Gorilla trying to prevent the recall, and he will for the moment anyway, but here comes Che up to the mid lane. Kuro has to back off for now. Good scene with the ward, though. Meanwhile, Winged in the bottom lane, just taking out that Rift Sculler. Well, in River, really. The River Lane.
It is a lane.
It is.
It's not really a river, though. It's basically two lakes.
It's more like a stream.
It doesn't go anywhere.
Isn't there, I think there's some sort of map suggestion that it flows underneath the mid lane or something like that. You know, that just comes up the other side. Like rivers do, you know?
I don't think so. I see a ramp going through. There's definitely like a fountain that comes out from the side to feed it. It's basically just a long rectangular fountain.
I suppose that. Well.
See, it doesn't go
right
there.
You're right, okay. So it is just two ponds. So we can't call it the double pond. I mean, that's kind of lame.
Top pond and bottom pond. Let's go.
All right. If you can keep that up for the rest of the game, we'll be very impressed.
It's okay. Just another instance of things being misnamed in League of Legends.
True. They're
clearly not the things.
Aiming is not the strong point. I call that a Zeer skin, the never going to get through a normal sized door skin. Because you're just your shoulders, your head are going to get stuck.
Yeah,
it's very awkward.
Why does he need shoulders like that? That's very inefficient.
makes up for the fact that he actually can't fly. It's kind of sad.
It actually would make him very easy to tackle. He's basically got giant handles.
That's true. Maybe he wants, maybe his sand soldiers ride on his back sometimes. It's like a little saddle or
something. Maybe a Yordle rides on his back. Yeah, I think that's better.
That's an original idea. They should make a champion like that. Oh, we have such good ideas. Maybe someday they'll do that.
Ride on the back of another champion into battle.
Brilliant.
Only has synergy with Yordles, though.
Yeah. It's about the lore, man. We can disable champions from lore. We can do this, too. Our pilot getting a lot of damage on a prey. Oh, actually gets condemned out of the death sentence. Oops.
Yeah, a bit of a misplay there, but they're still doing extremely well in this lane. I mean, look at that CS difference.
Yeah, it's definitely been a big problem for Prey to die early like that, and Jhin Air has taken good advantage of it. This is not a lane that they should be able to do this in.
Yeah, and again, without the engage, both of these compositions so reliant on the laning phase and the control over the dragon to make sure that they get their way, and with Prey behind early on, delaying that power spike.
There's a grab Prey. Prey just stood right in that. Yeah, because Wisdom is coming in. There's a knock up into the cocoon with the flash. Jhin in big trouble. Wisdom picks up a kill. And there we go.
And
that's what Ku needed.
Probably shouldn't go crazy like that if you don't know where their jungler is.
It's true. You're like, oh, I hooked that Corki suspiciously easily.
It was a really good condemn, but Trace had to cancel his TP. Now they're going to try and make a 2v2 play. We'll see if Ku is going to take the bait of this very delicious-looking Vayne. They know that Elise is in their jungle.
It's pretty. Well, there's the knockup. I feel like it's really obvious what Pilot is doing here. But maybe Gorilla doesn't see it.
Well, they
Wisdom
have Wisdom back
by.
Right now. It would be a 2v3.
Oh, well, there. Where did that ward come from? Oh, condemned. Gorilla goes to investigate and dies. The old ward bait. Here comes Wisdom. Can they make a play? Pilot is back, though. It's not a 2v2 anymore. Pilot really low, but no more flashes. He gets out on the lantern. Wisdom low health.
I don't know what Ku expected to happen right there.
Yeah, I mean, Gorilla saw the ward. And he's like, oh, I better go check this out.
Stand right there. For a setup.
Not a good idea.
Onto the condemn. So, and that gives Pilot more money. Just, he didn't get that first kill. Remember, the Ignite took it from Jhin. Now he actually has one.
You know, in all of that, the silver lining, I guess you could say, is that Prey was able to get an assist and catch up in CS.
Yeah, that CS actually coming back is quite large. That is a great point, though.
It does help. It's still awkward. You still gave away another kill, but. Whatever.
Pilot getting back into lane on the lantern, so he's not going to miss all of that. Nice farm. GBM getting pushed in early. Kuro now has that Azir. We've seen how that matchup in this series. We've seen it reversed now. So Kuro taking that advantage, pushing in early on, having that pink ward to make him safe, as well as the Scuttler control in the top side. And without kill pressure in the top lane, Wisdom can just play around the mid and the bottom.
You know, this gentleman Gnar really should just throw his hat, you know? Like Oddjob from from James Bond.
Oddjob, like the gentleman.
There you go. Yeah, I mean, he's short like Oddjob was in the movie, too. I feel like that was a golden opportunity missed right there.
Were you an Oddjob player in GoldenEye?
No, of course
Nintendo
not.
64?
Dude, Oddjob was always banned in every game, as he should be, of course. You never let anyone play Oddjob. Not in GoldenEye, no. Nice blue steal for the Ku Tigers. Wisdom able to grab that one.
Again, it's looking like almost a mirror of last game, right? Except the positions have been reversed. This time, it's the Azir from the Ku Tigers going in and stealing away that blue buff from Victor.
Ooh, early dragon too. Che's gonna find this. Kuro gets a little bit poked, and here comes Jhin Air to try to stop it. Oh yeah, they're gonna need to give it up, and Jhin Air may have just been gifted an easy dragon here.
Not so sure about that. TP coming in. Remember, Smeb has TP advantage.
Yeah, that's right. He's going to come from behind. He is Meganar right now. Yep, teleport coming in for Jhin Air as well, too. Wisdom gets in the back lines, gets very low. Pilot with a kill on the Gorilla right off the bat. And Prey in a lot of trouble. There's a kill for Wing. Three kills come in for Jhin Air. And man, did they need a team fight like that to start this game off. they're going to get the Dragon as well.
Yeah, due to the cancel from Trace, I thought his TP was still down, but it wasn't. And Che right there, a bad Gnar ult from Smeb. First off, it was only onto the Thresh. And second off, Che actually flashed it. So the Gnar ult was absolutely useless right there. And that just gives another kill over to this Vayne. Jhin Air in an extremely good position.
Yeah, I mean, Pilot is right on the edge of being able to totally go off.
Yeah, and look at this, Gorilla and Wisdom solo. Pilot just gets on top of him immediately, gets that early kill. And we saw that Gnar ult just not doing anything at all in that situation.
Yeah, meanwhile, Lulu's ult really doing a good job of keeping Pilot in the fight.
Yeah, well, that's the idea here. They pick that top lane Lulu.
Pretty much.
Or the help with the Vayne, and it couldn't be going better. 2-0-2 Vayne with a Lulu to help the Vayne out. This is absolutely fantastic for putting out damage. They've accelerated this Vayne to an absurd degree right now.
Yep. And if they can win, if Jhin Air can win, their fate still isn't really up to them, but they will have done everything they can.
Yes. They still require Najin to lose to Spenu tonight. Now, maybe they think that's more likely that Spenu beat Jhin Air, but still a large ask of
Spenu. Well, they beat us, so.
Especially because Jhin Air, or Najin rather, has been looking better and better.
Yeah. I mean, it's something. You've got hope, but it's not much hope, right?
No, it's a long shot, and it certainly didn't help that Jhin Air lost a game in this series.
Yeah. Yeah, that does mean that not only does Spenu need to win, they need to win 2-0, I believe.
Yeah, it's not a great situation for Jhin Air.
Well, we've certainly seen some upsets this season, so you never know. You
possibly
never know,
like this one.
Yeah.
Jhin Air is doing a great job of ignoring that supposed advantage that Ku had in the early game, picking up that first blood, and Pilot can really be a hero this game. He's already done with the Blade of the Ruined King at 12 minutes. There's huge kill pressure in bottom side.
Extremely fast. Repel used to get in onto Trace. Trace will use the shield on himself right away, but he's already super low health. Uses that Wild Growth, gets slowed. The Whimsy doesn't do a lot. Nice cocoon from Wisdom to set that one up for Smeb.
Yep, and we see Smeb going with the more aggressive option, opting for that Hex Drinker in this particular lane matchup, and with the Elise, gets enough damage down to take out the Lulu, even through the Wild Growth. They knew that he didn't have Flash Up.
This is true. Wisdom going
Hello.
Deep into the enemy jungle. He could be in trouble. Gravity Field doesn't quite catch him, and he's going to get some parting damage. Oh, Chaos Storm doesn't quite catch him, and Wisdom somehow makes it out.
GBM may have held on to his Chaos Storm there just a little bit too long.
I agree. If you would have dropped that right as Wisdom was coming in, it might have helped. Throw in a little bit of trouble, uses that Emperor's Divide and flashes over the wall to escape. GBM, yeah. A little bit of damage, but no Chaos Storm. Yeah. He popped his Ghost for that too, by the way.
Well, he popped the Ghost before he saw the Flash coming through. That was actually a good play by Jhin Air to try and set up a kill onto Kuro, but they got two Flashes for that. Winged had to flash for the Jhin Air side, but that's it's a lot of kill pressure they have onto Kuro in the mid lane now if Wing makes a return trip.
It is indeed. Kuro's still with the barrier, but he would ideally want a little bit more than that. GBM also getting a pretty big CS lead in the mid lane too.
Yeah, that's a bit surprising. I guess Kuro may have not picked up some CS while he was pushing very aggressively. Maybe he was zoned out a little bit. But that's it's a bit curious.
It is interesting. CS even more or less in the bottom lane and top lane. It's just the kills that are very much not even between Prey and Pilot.
Yeah, that factor really can't be understated, though. Pilot has shown that he is very proficient at playing this Vayne. It was when he came into the season, we didn't know he could do that. Of course, we knew him for his Corki, his Ezreal, just as a caster AD. So expanding his pool to include the Vayne, we've seen him have some very high-quality Vayne play.
Yeah, and really taking advantage of some of the setups from his teammates so far this game. About handovers. going on. Che thinking about coming around the side here. They've got three people. Would they maybe think about diving this, I wonder? No, it doesn't look like it.
Wisdom back up in the top side, in spite of the fact that Trace is so far pushed under his turret. Looks like he's just there to cover Smeb. The mini wave pushing back out, Wing now.
Well, they don't have
on the
wards.
Bottom side of the map. I don't think Trace is going to be playing this particularly aggressively. They're probably not going to find anything here, especially with Smeb, who is tired at the moment.
Yeah, they'll be able to get some decent poke onto the turret, at least, it looks like. Trey condemned against the wall, but because of the turret shot, he trades fairly evenly. Wow, Smeb. Going pretty deep against Trace and taking a lot of damage.
They know that Wisdom's on top right now. Wisdom revealed himself. This could be a dive coming in. Is Wing or Che going to actually delay him? No, they will not. So he does get out with a recall. Will this cost them a turret, though? 15 seconds until the dragon.
He's lucky the minion wave was there. Whoa, ult onto Trace. There's the stuns lined up, and Trace is in a lot of trouble. No flash. The shield isn't enough flash. The auto, wow, he barely got him. I think he actually missed one of those autos after the flash, but it was just enough.
And Trace did not have wild growth. I don't know when he used it earlier, but it was down. What a great read by Smeb to go all in.
I believe it was actually just about to come up from the last time he used it and died.
Yeah. Seems like it was a while ago, but that's very well possible. And in any case, a really good all in there from Smeb to keep him stun locked.
Jhin'Air gets their second dragon at least, so they do get something out of it, but they lose the top turret at the same time.
Yeah, lose the top tower. It is about even in gold again, but again, it's about Jhin'Air and their ability to play in the late game. They simply have far more late game damage, and the champion that had to get fed in the Vayne got fed. They got the turret now in the bottom side. They're controlling the dragon. Jhin'Air has an excellent ability to kite with this Vayne. And Ku doesn't have answers to a fed Vayne. Smeb is going to have to come up with some really amazing flash Gnars because that's the only solution they have to this Vayne at all. They have no backline threat.
Well, luckily for Smeb, and luckily for the Ku Tigers as well, too, he has two kills. He's been able to get a pretty decent start at building into a tanky Gnar that can handle that and get into the back lines.
Well, he may have the two kills, but so does Vayne. And Vayne has the two assists. Vayne is just going to be right even with him in terms of items, and that's not what they need. They need Smeb to get something more than that.
Yeah.
With all the peel, too, against this Gnar, the play, the Lee Sin kick, the gravity field. How are you going to get this flash ult? And even then, what happens when Pilot gets a QSS or Che gets a Mikhail's Crucible? It's a really tough situation for Ku to be in. Even though they've managed to pull back in terms of gold, rough, very rough.
TBM with a little bit of poke onto Kuro here in this mid lane. Both the junglers are pretty close by. So just gonna carefully make his way out of lane.
There are pings now coming down onto the turret from Jhin'Air, just trying to get there before the Trinity Force Corki has a chance to do much of any damage to the tower.
Looks like GBM is going for a death cap for his first big item here after a couple of Hextech Core upgrades. Just going for a ton of AP.
Yep, once that burst, knows that he can kill Kuro, he can kill Prey. That'll be the end of a team fight right there. Aegis already completed for
Cool. Takes a dark passage out of that one.
Death Sentence comes in. Doesn't actually land onto anyone. Ku trying to get some invade. They want to just play around this top side right now. See how far they can push it. Maybe they can translate some wards and the threat of Gnar and Elise in the mid lane into that mid lane tower. They desperately want that right now. They are going to get a red buff.
Jhin'Air is just doing such a good job controlling the map right now, too. Taking a lot of Ku Tigers jungle at the moment.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a top side, bottom side game. It's Ku's on the top side with that 2-0 Gnar. It's Jhin'Air's on the bottom side with that 2-0-2 Vayne.
Oh, there's a nice kick onto Prey forcing him out. Can they catch him? He's going to Valkyrie right away, but I think it's only a matter of time. There's the flash. Pilot catching up to Prey, doing a lot of damage. Prey turns around and is able to deal some himself, but Pilot is able to pick up that kill.
Yeah, yet another kill for the Vayne. They go all in on that dive. After taking that red buff, they realize that there's not anybody else down there to help Prey, and Prey just left out to dry this game. They're trying to feed Smeb instead.
Was it worth it to flash there? Because they knew they were going to catch him. So did they really need to commit that summoner to do it?
It did seem likely that they would catch him, but there's a possibility that Smeb could have TP'd and maybe turned that around. So I think you just go for it and you don't take that risk.
Better
obviously, Trace could have maybe gotten there too, but Smeb is the fed one. And so you have to be a little bit reluctant to play against him right now.
I mean, we did see how much damage Prey did when he turned around onto the Bane just for that moment, too. So you do have to play it a little bit carefully.
Well, it's right in his power spike, right? It doesn't get much better than this for a Corki. Sork Shoes, Trinity Forest. This is the point of the game where he is comparatively most powerful.
Can they translate that into any objectives, though?
Yes. Well, with a 302 Vayne, gotta wonder. Gotta wonder pretty seriously.
It's gonna be tough if you try to push up onto a turret. Jhenair can just fight you.
Yes. Yes, they can. And Jhenair looking to get their third dragon. Man, if they can get three dragons at 22 minutes with a Vayne Victor into it, Azir Corki, that is just insane. That should not happen.
Yeah, no kidding. And Prey dying three times already in this game certainly doesn't help. Nice dodge by Smeb. Has to be careful there, though. There's a lot of damage from GBM, but they managed to clear the wards.
Well, Smeb has to be the hero, right?
Yep.
He is the one that needs to carry the Ku Tigers right now.
45 seconds until the next dragon. And if there was ever a time to push and try to take a little bit of map control back for the Ku Tigers, it's right now. How do you do it?
Now Lulu's pushed back, but Trace is losing this lane, of course, but losing it gracefully, not overextending any further, knows that there is that kill pressure, knows how many wards are in that topside jungle. So they're just going to push up with Vayne for a little bit more. Wing steals away the Raptor, and there is no Corki, so guess what? Vayne gets a ton of free autos onto this tower.
And just going to take it, it looks
like. Jeez, free tier 2. More gold concentrated onto this Vayne. Another 250.
Wow.
And dragging up in 1 second.
Yep, and Kuro's taking the wolves at the same time. Doesn't look like Ku Tigers are even going to try to stop this. That's three dragons at 22 minutes.
Yeah, that is quite early, of course, for those three dragons. 34 minutes for a possible fifth dragon from Jhenair.
It's really, really not looking like Ku Tigers are going to be able to turn this one around. I mean, the gold's still very even, but they're going to need to have a couple of very, very lucky picks here.
Yep, and look at this. They still have control of the top side. That's what they've got going for them. Ku, maybe they can pull out a Baron if they can try and sneak it or if they can get the right pick.
Yeah.
So the right pick is down to Elise.
Yep, well, I mean, it's a great champion to do that with. Just trying to find a position, but Jhenair has also been really good this game about warding everything, too. It's very hard for Wisdom to find a way to get in that Jhenair doesn't know about.
Yeah, even when their top side has been saturated, they've still managed to get a couple of wards in without getting picked off. Pilot playing a little bit dangerously right now, of course. There's so much vision for the Vayne.
I guess so. He's got that support from the support and jungler, too.
So here we go. They want the tier one. Jhenair still has their sights set on compounding their advantage. They've taken out so many wards now from Ku.
It's still not the greatest siege for Jhenair, I suppose.
Oh, yeah, it's not good at all. I suppose you have a laning Lulu, so you get the whimsy and the shield onto Vayne.
Yeah. Oh, Majai's. Majai's from Trace.
Ooh, I like it.
Okay,
the confidence from Trace.
I had a rough early game, but don't worry, guys. I'm
shake
gonna buy
it off
gonna
with
be
this
fine.
Giant snowball item.
That's right. He's going to have to snowball off assists, though, probably. Assists delivered to him by that Vayne.
Or the Victor, I mean. Can't discount. He's already has a death cap here. So not going to be a low damage champion by any stretch of the imagination. pilots still here. All of the wards are expiring for Ku in the enemy jungle.
Yeah, and there's not a lot of support for Prey and Gorilla up in this top lane. I mean, Wisdom is not around. Wink is still there. Smep trying to split push.
Yeah, is doing some work on that bottom turret. Trace has the wave clear, but it's not going to be quite as much, of course, with that Medjize instead of going into a death cap like we would normally see. Trace spent a lot of money just on home guard boots to get to lanes quicker, so.
EVM with another blue. Smep might be able to push down this turret eventually. It's going to take a long time.
Yeah, but Trace doesn't have any other option as long as they just keep leaving him there. See how much damage Trace is taking.
Certainly
rating very favorably.
He's got the Glitter Lance at least, so it's going to take a while for Smeb to get enough damage onto the turret to kill it. This wave clear isn't bad for Lulu.
All right, red buff for Pilot. He's got the Last Whisper now. Third core item already completed. Look at Prey. Look how far behind Prey is.
Yeah.
He doesn't even have anywhere close to a completed Blade of the Ruined King yet.
Well, this is an exceptionally bad game for Prey at an exceptionally bad time for Ku Tigers. Pilot's just going to take this tier 1 up in top without any issue.
It's so much money for Vayne because she keeps getting solo gold on these towers, too. It's even more deceptive than it looks.
Already has that Last Whisper, so Smeb, his tankiness is basically non-existent at this point. Yeah, he does get the turret, though.
Yeah, Smeb, that's their only hope right now. They know that. Prey has to take a hit. He has taken a hit. He's 50 CS down. Down 3 kills and an assist.
Wow.
And Smeb, it's all on him. He needs to stop the Vayne, and it is going to be tough.
Another dragon in minute 40 as Wisdom gets poked out pretty heavily. And 4 dragons would be pretty amazing for Jhin Air to have right now.
Maybe Ku thinks that there's an outside shot of them actually just who's going to take that. Looks like it will be Pilot in the end. The blue buff take.
Okay. Yeah, how do you win this miracle fight? What do you do? I mean, you need to have wards. You need to get some sort of flank with Smeb to start a team fight near Dragon, probably. But Jhin Air can just give away this next Dragon if they want to and take a turn or two.
Yeah, and you're right. How do they win this next fight? Well, at least Smeb has Flash. You'll notice he went Distortion Enchantment again because he knows he needs that Flash up as much as possible, or he is never going to kill GBM and Pilot.
A nice kill taken. Yeah, they were able to get it.
They have Azir Corki. They're still having a strong mid game. They can take out turrets, that is for sure. Very strong siege composition from the Ku Tigers. Range jungler, fantastic siege. Uh-oh.
Oh boy, Wink may be in a little bit of trouble here. Here comes Gnar. Wink gets out on the Lantern. Another nice save by Che. And that not only saved Wink there, that might have saved the Dragon too.
Yes, so Dragon, Jhin Air, they're going to get into the river first. Looks like GBM taking a bit of a late recall, but that allows him to buy an Abyssal Scepter.
Certainly something that'll help them out in this next dragon fight.
Okay, they're setting up for a pick. Pink ward right there.
Yep.
They're not going to walk next to that brush. It's pretty clear that with Smeb and Prey, they're not doing the Baron at the moment.
Pink goes down from Jhin Air to start to move towards that dragon. Winged is going to investigate it first, and they're going to get some decent wards down. Now Ku just going right for Baron at the moment.
Yep, that's the right call for
them. They're going to trade it. And actually, Jhin Air backing off the dragon. They want to stop this Baron, but it's going down pretty quickly, surprisingly enough. Trace is there, but Ku Tigers, they're going to get this Baron. They will. Can they win the next team fight, though? Can Jhin Air get there in time? No, they can't. And so Ku gets away with a Baron, but can they stop that fourth dragon from being taken by Jhin Air?
Yeah, Jhin Air needs this fourth dragon right now. They have to get this, and if there's a fight, then so be it. But everyone back on Ku, so they've decided to give up that dragon. They want to go back and buy, and now it's up to what Ku can do. There were wards at that dragon. Trace actually used Whimsy to go and place them, but Ku was able to burst it down fast enough before Jhin Air could actually respond.
That gives them a little bit of a window here.
That was a gutsy call from Ku. It was the right one, though, because they should be very scared about what these Baron stacks or these Dragon stacks mean.
Well, yeah.
So they had to go for the Baron. But It all comes down to now, how big of an advantage can they get? They have a great siege composition. Jhin Air only has really the Victor for the wave clear because of the low AP onto Trace right now. And they're pushing up.
Yeah, here comes two Tigers to try to take this 2-2 turret mid lane. They've got the Baron minions. They're doing a lot of damage to it. Will Jhin Air engage? Nice poking from Kuro too, and that's gonna let them get one turret out of it.
They need to get at least all of the inner turrets to make this really effective and to start getting enough of a lead onto their carries that their team comp starts doing damage again. They do not need to be caught out
like
this.
That is not a good place for a bell. Oh, the death sentence missed. Chain mistimed it. Wisdom was able to flash out of that one. Turning around now. Pilot, Wild Growth used on him to keep himself right away. Jhin Air was expecting more of a fight. That's a couple ultimates out of the way that Ku really is happy to see go.
Man, if Jay had not mistimed his death sentence right there and he had actually caught the Elise, that could have been a little bit different. That would have been very hard to do, but at least they get a flash, they punish it, and they delay the Ku Tigers from setting up for another siege.
Now, Ku Tigers, there's a heal just to keep the minions and everyone else healthy as they come in. They're going to try to take this tier two, and they can't really fight this with Vayne without that Wild Growth. It's just a bit too dangerous. That's the way it's looking anyway right now. The turret's going to go down, and they get two. Okay, so that's two of the inner turrets taken off of this Baron buff.
You know why I love watching the Ku Tigers, Doa?
Why is that?
Because on the fly, they have such an insane understanding of win conditions. By doing something right there, like popping the Monsoon just to heal them back off after they got poked a little bit, they were committing just to killing that tower and then backing off. But they know they have to get as many towers as they can right now. They knew earlier that they needed to get that Baron. Otherwise, they were going to be in a position where Jhin Air was just sitting there waiting for that final fifth dragon stack.
Yeah.
And they couldn't fight Jhin Air either because of what has happened with the Vayne in this game.
Well, the Ku Tigers have gotten so many wards down too throughout all of this that they've taken back a lot of the map control.
It's just disappointing that the Ku Tigers always find themselves in these holes in the early game or giving kills over to exactly the wrong champions. Because if they had some more early game punch, their shot calling is so spot on. They're incredibly adaptable to the circumstances of a game and what exactly they need to do.
Yeah. They are kind of in this sort of worst of the best situation here, and they're going to try to catch, or Jhin Air's going to try to catch Smeb here. The Q doesn't land. They get the flash.
It's huge.
Yeah, Pilot just using his ult. That'll be back up pretty soon.
Absolutely huge. They need that flash to be up to control Pilot.
Well, they definitely can't get in on him now.
And especially because the only other option for getting on to Pilot is Flash Cocoon. That's down two from Wisdom.
Yeah, they're going to need to rely on some sort of mispositioning, but Pilot not really showing that he's got any intention to do that this game.
He also has QSS now.
So that helps too.
That is an extra bonus. That is a very crucial item. Trace now gets the death gap, so finally he's going to be a bit more useful when it comes to helping out the Vayne. And by the way, you know what's funny is sometimes we used to hear the old excuse of, well, I got Magi's because I didn't have enough money for a needlessly large rod. Well, guess what? That excuse doesn't exist anymore.
Thanks for fixing that one, Ryan. That is nice.
That doesn't exist anymore, so we can't hear it. It's actually no longer. You can explain your questionable decisions away with that logic. Doesn't work.
With reducing price, though, does that mean the rod got smaller, too? Is it not quite a needlessly large rod?
Oh,
I know the AP went down.
Large rod.
It's like a moderately large rod at this point, you know? I don't know if it's needlessly large anymore. I think it's just about appropriately large rod. Right? I'm pretty sure they're going to change the name.
Yeah, that's what Riot does.
They'll just name the rod Ratatat. That'll fix it.
I think they should just call it Rod.
Purple Rod.
Purple Rod.
Yeah, that's right. There you go. Who wouldn't want to buy that?
Who wants a needlessly large rod anyway? Its utility and its usefulness is just reflected inherently in its name.
By definition, it seems inefficient. You know, it seems like you could be getting maybe a couple other rods of more appropriate size and storing them in the same space.
Yeah, it's unfortunate that it is, in fact, so damn efficient. Yeah. You wouldn't guess it from the name.
I know.
Well, 15 seconds up until this next dragon right now. That is a crucial moment for Jyn Air.
Well, Ku Tigers have a good position on this,
yes,
too, unless the Jyn Air can come in. And they cannot let them get this fifth dragon. GBM being aggressive. They caught Wisdom. Wisdom in a lot of trouble there. Sir Pelly's only at half health. Smeb getting poked as well, too. Wisdom manages to get out for now. Smeb very low. And Ku, oh man, they lost a lot of health on some very important members of their team. And immediately, Jyn Air starts that dragon. This is it. This is Jyn Air's season right here on this dragon. Can they get it? Getting lower, they're going to need Wisdom to take this one. Wisdom comes in to try to steal. GBM gets a kill onto Prey. And they're pushing away the Ku Tigers. Wisdom comes in again, gets kicked out. Trace kills him. And there's the dragon. That's five stacks for Jyn Air and a huge Gnarl from Smeb. It's not enough to turn it around, though. Gorilla's still low. GBM with yet another kill. Pilot over the wall to take down Trace. And that is going to be a massive advantage. Now the Baron is up. Jyn Air's going to walk right over and take it.
We'll see if they do that. I think they should just push through right now and try and get as many towers as possible.
We'll see. I guess they can just push right down.
They're going to do it?
Okay, they're going to do it.
They're low. Remember, they don't really have a true tank, and Wisdom getting cut out there was calamitous.
Can Kuro poke enough, though? I mean, he doesn't have his flash. They can turn and kill him so easily.
That's true.
All Kuro can do is push the mid lane, so this should be safe. And it is.
It is, and they had the Wild Growth again to use onto Wings.
Yeah.
Wow, that team fight right there. So let's take a look at this. They catch Prey. Prey questionably positioned, and he's just exploded by GBM. So Prey too far forward, easily caught out by the death sentence. And now Smeb's going to go Meganar, and he's going to get it. But Pilot has that QSS, dodges out, tumbles out of the subsequent stun, and then follows over with the flash.
Tried to tumble through a wall there. It didn't work out.
Sounds painful.
Got the kill anyway, yeah. Because you're more tumbling into the wall at that point, and nobody likes that.
Well, cool. Jyn Air is going to stay alive, at least for now. We will see what happens with Najin.
And they still need to win the game, but they've got five dragons, and they've got the Baron, so it would be the most massive of massive throws if Jyn Air loses this game.
It definitely would be.
Yeah.
In spite of their relatively poor siege, they have an insane amount of advantages. They'll be able to, holy cow.
Oh, wow.
That turret damage with five dragons.
And the Baron.
And the Lich Bane onto GBM. That was actually a great buy for fifth dragon.
GBM gets caught a little bit here. Doesn't take a whole lot of damage, though. They use the Wild Growth. So Pilot's going to need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, still that poke. But what a great buy for five dragons. Just having that Lich Bane right now, because the 30% extra damage to turrets with a Lich Bane means that these towers don't stand much of a chance at all.
Nope.
Oh, just siege. Stop doing buffs.
Well, they need to wait for the minion wave, I guess. Oh, but the minion wave's dead.
No. Jyn Air, it doesn't get much better for sieging than you've got right now. I guess they want to go for another tier two.
They're like, it's not 45 minutes yet. We can't end the game. Prey, though, it's very disturbing to see kind of where his position's been at. Oh, Wisdom gets caught a little bit as well. Pushed against the wall with that Condemn. Pilot running ahead, bloodthirsty. Can he get the kill, though? Yes, well, he tries. Shay takes it. There we go. That was appropriately bloodthirsty. Another turret falls, and Jyn Air trying to steamroll their way into the base now. No Wisdom to worry about. Whoa, Wing tries to get in, gets pushed out by the Emperor's Divide. They got two ults out of that aggressive play. GBM getting a little bit crazy here. Tries to take out Kuro, and he nearly does. They're going to get the inhibitor turret. And Smeb just cannot stand
Bane
against this Bane.
He's doing so much damage.
Whoa.
Has to use.
Kuro kills Pilot, though.
Yeah. Does get the kill, pushes a little bit too far forward.
I guess so, yeah.
So Smeb will live through that. Had to use his flash. But inhibitor down, so much gold picked up by Jyn Air. Just an incredible gold swing off of that fight. They continue to get the fifth dragon.
I mean, and Jyn Air has been able to take a gold deficit after Ku got the Baron and pushed down a few turrets to now having a 4,000 gold lead after all that.
The Ku Tigers, man, if they could clean up their early game or their laning phase, their shot calling, it's incredible that they can get back into games like we've seen here. Sure, they're probably going to lose this one in the end, but yeah. The fact that they made it competitive in the mid game is something that is a gift of theirs, really. And I hope they do something during the offseason to shape up their laning, because if that can be changed, then this could be an extraordinarily powerful team.
One thing that worries me with the Ku Tigers, though, is that Prey's positioning seems to be getting progressively worse as the season goes on here, and he's kind of returning to that pre-year-long break Prey that we saw more or less retire.
Yeah.
He came back, played really well, but I don't know what it is. It seems like he's kind of slipping into some old bad habits.
I agree. There's not really another way to say it. Besides that, maybe they have to start looking at getting another AD carry on the roster.
Maybe. Let's see. So we've...
They can just borrow one from IM. They have three.
That's true.
You don't need three there. AD carries, IM.
Maybe you do. You never know. I mean, IM's a team that will just throw Lilac in any position they feel like, so maybe those ADCs are just ADCs in name only.
Man, I would love to see Fury go to the Ku Tigers. That would be just an insane pickup for
wow.
them.
Yeah, you're right. Be pretty incredible. Or even someone like... Nuclear may be a bit of a stretch for Spenu. I think he's a pretty good ADC, honestly, but Prey may still have the edge there. Oh, GBM. Whoa, goodbye. Goodbye,
yes.
Gorilla.
The old GBM Victor Brush trick. He loves that one.
Yep, hide in a brush and destroy their support. Yeah, the good thing to do right before you have a chance to get another fifth dragon.
Here we go. This one is definitely going to be uncontested as Ku just heads back to their base to take care of super minion waves. Baron up in a minute and a half. These objectives should just fall like dominoes for the generic Green Wings, who, after coming off some embarrassing losses, 1-2 up against Spenu, giving them their first win of the season after they lost 15 straight best of threes. Then 0-2 to Anarchy, and now the Ku Tigers on the verge of losing to this team.
Man, Jinera really looked like they hit rock bottom against Anarchy in the match last week, but they've managed to salvage it a little bit. And even if Spenu doesn't win against Najin next match, at least Jinera can exit with their heads held high as long as they don't lose a crazy team fight before this is all over.
Well, you know, the craziest thing for this for Najin is their fate is in their own hands, right? They need to win, but if they win today, they will actually go above Ku in the standings. Ku getting dangerously close to they will be in the fifth seed.
Yeah,
if that happens tonight, that is not where you want to start out.
It's a bad situation.
In the playoffs.
I mean, because that means you need to win the maximum amount of best of fives to get to the finals. And you start out with the lowest circuit points gained if you lose, too. So.
And they're number two in circuit points right now.
Yeah. And again, the world's qualification is another gauntlet. So the circuit points you gain from the gauntlet here is also very important for worlds as well.
Wow, Pilot does a lot of damage.
Yes, he does. He's even got Mercurial Scimitar at this point.
Six-item Vayne with no defensive item. I don't know how wise that is. Maybe get rid of the ship right now.
And I mean, he's got a QSS, technically.
I suppose.
And what else does a Vayne need, That's more defensive items than Vayne's normally build. I guess so. Wow, that Baron died fast. So another 5 dragon with Baron situation for Ku to deal with, and didn't go too well last time.
Here we go again. This is actually, I think, the only time we've seen 2 5 dragon and Baron on one team in one game.
Usually doesn't take more than one, does it?
Well, they did get it a very early 5th dragon this game.
Yes. But still, it usually doesn't take more than one. Inhibitor back in the top lane, by the way.
Especially with this Lich Bane Victor.
Yeah, well, Jinera's going to take out this Inhibitor again immediately. And Jinera trying to push their way in here.
Again, Jinera really doesn't have very good siege composition either. And they also have no real tank like a Gnar or a Maokai to walk up on the turret. Trace just can't do that.
And just rotating back to the jungle, I guess. Meet up with their lane and mid. They do have a wave in bot lane that they need to worry about a little bit, I guess. And Jhinnair, keep in mind, it wasn't quite as drastic, but they did have a game where it was similar to this in the early game. They didn't have the advantages with buffs that they had, but they still did lose one team fight against Spenu, and that's all it could take. If Ku wins a big team fight, they can probably just steamroll their way in and win.
I agree, and we're reaching the 150,000 total gold point in the game, and six items on everybody. So Jhinnair is playing a dangerous game. They need to close now.
Is that a problem?
They no longer have fifth dragon. They just have Baron.
Yeah, and they're going to try to come in and take this inhibitor turret mid. They took the inhibitor in top lane again a moment ago. And this is it. The last defense for Ku. One of the last defenses.
If they lose this game, it is going to be a disaster.
Yeah.
But well, definitely within the realm of possibility. Sure, Ku may not have very much damage, but one good Gnar ult could really still change this.
We saw Ku lose a game that they really shouldn't have lost due to a very late game team fight, and we've seen Jhinnair lose a game that they probably shouldn't have lost due to a pretty bad late game team fight. So both of these teams kind of have a history with that situation happening, which is not exactly something you want to be known for.
No, it's not. There was an excuse for Ku, though.
That was a massively good fight by KT, too.
Yes, in that they did not have a late-game team composition.
That's true as well.
They really played hard for the mid-game, and KT put on an epic defense to win it, and it was just barely in that case. Okay, no more boots.
Just picking up the Zephyr. Here comes giant Lee Sin. Wow, he is huge compared to that Vayne. Yeah, really, though, Lulu is about as tall as Vayne.
Yeah, Yordles aren't actually that small. Did you notice that Corki is considerably smaller than most other Yordles?
Well, yeah, he has to fit in that plane somehow. So is Rumble.
But isn't it a lore reason that Rumble is small, even for
a
Yordle?
Well, yeah, he's supposed to be a runt. And that's why he built the mech suit, right? To be like, I'm going to be tough in other ways. I can't be one of those big, muscular Yordles. Like, apparently the other ones are. I don't know how that works.
Damn those muscular Yordles.
I know, right?
Always stealing away all the attention.
That's what happens. All right. Maybe the bottom lane will work. Nope, wave through too good. They're going to try to split here. They've done a lot of damage to this mid lane turret. Gorilla making a big difference with those shields on the turrets as well at this point. Oh, that was really, really close. Oh, man. I mean, he has his Mercurial Scimitar, so he can get out of that, something like a cocoon, but you don't want to put yourself in that position either way.
No, you don't, because then the Gnar ult becomes the big threat, and you don't have a way to stop that.
Yep.
And if you can't stop the ult, you're not going to stop the chain stun that comes in afterward either.
Slowly but surely, Jhinnair is poking away at these inhibitor turrets.
Team Yum should really just go mid right now. He doesn't need to be on the bottom side.
He is.
Lich Bane. Well, somebody has to go deal with the Nexus turrets. One of them's going to go down.
Yeah, Prey nearly getting himself caught again, and that might be the ticket that Jhinnair needs to come in here. They got the mid lane inhibitor turret. And can they take the inhibitor now?
Now just keep on doing this. Jhinnair has no reason to stop doing what they're doing.
Yep.
Now they can go back down. Sure, Pilot got poked just a little bit, but he has enough lifesteal just to heal off the wave.
Or heal off of anyone who wants
to
try to fight him.
Dragon number five, attempt
this
three.
This is our third, fifth dragon. Has that ever happened before? 3 5 dragon buffs?
Not in Korea.
That's what I was asking about here in Champions. I don't know about the other regions, but we have not seen this before. And Baron is up for 2 minutes, so we might actually see 3 5 dragon and Baron at the same time. What a defense.
Well, Trace is actually committing to this. They are just going to TP into the bottom side. They want to use it they should. Now, Ku did get a bit of time to push out the minion waves thanks to the fallback for the dragon. All right, so we are going to have GBM go clear the wave so we can actually kill this last turret. Again, Jhinnair really does have not a great siege composition, so that's why this is taking so long.
Only a tiny amount of health left on that inhibitor turret, though, so one short move in should be able to do it. Here they go. little bit of damage. They took off the shield. The shield's back on.
Top inhibitor's back up. That's how long this has been going on.
That's insane. That's the second time it's come back up as well, too. Wisdom got poked. There it is. There's the turret. Just a little bit of poke is all it took. And now the third inhibitor is going to go down. Pretty soon. Maybe not quite yet. Oh, they'll get it. There we go.
Pilot.
He needs to be careful here. Wow, takes some damage before he gets out, but he gets the inhibitor.
He does get the inhibitor. Now you can see the Lee Sin already curving around on the outside of the base. They want to take it out winged. Cannot get caught here.
Yeah, but here comes the rest of the Jhin Air team. I don't think they're too worried with Pilot being this jugger vein at this point. They're going to grab Snap, bring him into the box. Could this be the fight here? Che getting poked really hard. There's a knockup. They're going to lose the inhibitor. They nearly lost their support as well. And Ku's going to back off. I think they're just going to go for Baron.
Jhin Air wants the Baron now. The inhibitors are down. And this is the right call, right? You can't bolt them for this. It's this safe call. You just took down all the inhibitors. And now you can actually just go for the Baron and push into the enemy base. It is so important that they win this game that this presents the least likely method of Ku making a comeback.
Yep. And so, just like we predicted, three Dragon Stacks, three Barons. That's what it takes, apparently, to close out this game. So Smeb has GA and Thornmail now. We're still in that position where if he can get like a good ult off onto Pilot, and if the thing is, if Jhin Air loses Pilot, maybe they might lose a team fight to Ku.
All right, Trinity Force now done for Pilot. He has so much money, he's going to place all of his items with more expensive ones. Trinity Force very good on Vayne late.
Of course.
Also helping out, considering he doesn't have boots.
Who needs boots when you can tumble? Oh, Pilot comes in for some damage onto Smeb. And I don't think he's worried about the Thornmail. Jeez. That does it. Smeb very, very low. Nobody's going to stop this Vayne. And that's one kill already. GBN picks it up. And Vayne has gone Super Vayne at this point. A big Gnarl, but it doesn't matter. That is the end of it. Triple kill for GBM. As Jhin Air closes it out, they are still alive, barely alive, but still alive.
They are, and now their trip to the playoffs will depend on what happens in our next match with Najin.
Spenu needs to 2-0 Najin.
Yes.
To help Jhin Air get to the playoffs.
Yeah, that's right, but let's talk about what can happen now, because the Ku Tigers dropped to 10-7. They are really struggling. We thought they would just be a shoe-in tonight given Jhin Air's recent performance, but Ku continues to have trouble. Man, Pilot was doing 1,000 damage crits on champions in that last fight. Absolutely huge amounts of damage.
That is crazy. Well, Jhin Air with some roster swapping, able to get the win over the Ku Tigers.